Hey, how's it going, guys? The stream should now be live. Sorry for the hold up there. It's my first time using the live event system rather than just using stream now, but I think everything should be running. Yeah, it's all good. Okay, that was simpler to set up than I expected. I was expecting it to be an absolute fucking nightmare, but that went not so bad. Ooh, that's a mistake. Didn't mean to be looping in the live audio there. There, that's taken care of. I'm an amateur. Sorry about that. So, today I'm sitting down and playing Full Throttle Remastered. It just came out. It's a remastered game done by Double Fine, and the game was originally made back in 95, so 22 years ago. Hey, Josh, hey, how's it going, buddy? I'm doing well. How about yourself? So the game came out back in 95, 22 years ago, with LucasArts and Tim Schafer, who now is like the CEO of Double Fine, was, I think, the designer on this game. This might have been early enough in his career that he was still just like a programmer or a script supervisor or something. But it's part of Double Fine's lineup of remastered LucasArts games that Tim had worked on. They did Grim Fandango, and then The Day of the Tentacle, and now it's all coming together with Full Throttle. I've never played this. I'm very excited to sit down and check it out, and I'm happy that you guys are here to check it out. Thank you, Josh, for tuning in. I think I'm gonna fire her up and see how it goes. I'm expecting a little bit of cutscenes and stuff like that up at the top here, so I'll just kind of sit back and let that play out. Oh, what kind of games were you playing, Josh? Yeah, there's the LucasArts, which originally made the game. I wonder if they're still going to have, like, Double Fine branding.
I think of Marine. That's the last sensation I had before I blacked out. The thick smell of asphalt. And the first thing I saw when I woke up was her face. She said she'd fix my bike. Free. No strings attached. I should have known then that things are never that simple.
I'll look into getting subtitles set up. That's my mistake that they aren't on now.
Two things: asphalt and trouble.
Rip Burger, you're dumber than dirt.
This hover car?
Mr. Corley, if you'd only listen to my plan, my vision. I know your plan, Rip Burger. You're waiting for me to die so you can take over my company.
Rip
That's
Burger.
Horrible. I am not waiting for you to die. You know, I've never liked you, Rip. But you have business know-how and killer instincts that I respect.
Why, thank you, sir.
But this latest idea of yours...
Big wide eyes for a second there.
...riding up to our shareholders meeting with a gang of bikers? Who do you think you're fooling?
The shareholders, sir. It's good PR to be seen hobnobbing with real Corley Motors customers.
What do you know about our customers, Adrian? You've never even been on a bike.
Well, you know I'd be on one right now, sir, if it weren't for my destabilizing inner ear condition.
Ah, your ears are fine. It's what's between them that scares me.
It's interesting they point out the art style, because this is all the remastered. The original was like full pixel art, but it would have been limited to like a very cropped aspect ratio. And so they had to redo all of the art in order to expand it to like the full aspect ratio. And so while they were at it, we were like, might as well clean things up and like smooth it all out. There you go.
Now there goes some boys I can ride with.
Driving in the middle of the road. Yeah, you're right. I hadn't noticed that, but they are. What a bunch of jerkwads. I guess they got no respect for the law. Unlike these road warriors, these thugs who know nothing but the rules of the road. I'm pretty sure the main character's name is something Throttle. He's like Brian Throttle or something like that. I'm not sure if Brian is a cool enough guy name. That was a badass shot. I like the way it swiveled around the motorcycle there. It looked awesome. Woohoo! Starring Roy Conrad. Mark Hamill? Mark Hamill's in this game? Oh, that's awesome. Oh shit, I'm trying to think. Like, I wonder if we've heard his voice already or not. I'm guessing Roy Conrad is our main character here, but I don't know that for sure. I'm probably not going to recognize many of these names. Some people might still be around. P. Peter Chan. He works at Double Fine now. I know that name. I've probably missed a few other ones. They're going by a little quickly. But chances are a handful of these people all work at Double Fine nowadays. I haven't seen Tim's name on here yet. But I wonder, they probably left this opening credits untouched, is my guess. And then they'll include, like, the remastered editions credits later on or something. Ron Gilbert, he does a lot of adventure games. He worked for Double Fine for a little while, at least. Now he's been doing some of his own stuff. He's always got some of his own stuff going on. He did the Deathspank series. He did The Cave with Double Fine. I hope the music isn't copyrighted. You know, I've never had an issue with that before. And I'm thinking it's because I'm such a small writer, designer, project lead, Tim Schafer. Oh wait, Tim was the project lead on this. I've always hoped it was because I was a small enough channel that I didn't get the copyright, like, audio shutdowns.
You know, Ben, we're broke.
Yeah.
Ben Throttle.
Don't come our way soon. We're in big trouble.
Relax. I have a feeling something's coming our way. Something big.
I'm glad to see I got the views and likes bar thing figured out. I think it's working the way it's supposed to. I may have still screwed it up.
All right. Who's the guy that drove over my car? What could possibly be taking so long?
Maybe old man Corley got himself in trouble.
Yeah, maybe they took the old guy out back and worked him over with a 2x4.
Is that Maurice LaMarche? That sounded a lot like Braid from Biggie and the Braid.
More likely he's boring them to death with some...
The same thing we do every night, Pinky. I don't know how to do a Braid impression.
But Malcolm, isn't that illegal?
Not back then it wasn't.
Oh, they're just friends. They're having fun.
These days.
He rides with me. Although I'm sure he'd much rather be riding with your little club.
I told you to wait out in the limo, Ripburger.
I thought you might like some help with your sales pitch, sir.
Sales pitch? Music in the background there.
We've come here today to offer you and your men employment. Mr. Corley requires an escort to the annual Corley Motors shareholders meeting.
Does this look like an escort service to you?
You would be well compensated for your time, of course.
Not interested.
It's fairly obvious that you could use the money.
Listen, I said we're not for rent. The Polecats are not goons for hire.
Polecats.
Not even if it were
cool gang name.
Corley's dying wish.
It's very borderline cool and not cool.
That does it. I'm gonna...
Hold on there, Malcolm. If you don't mind, I'd like to step outside with Mr. Ripburger for a little chat.
Excellent idea.
Are they gonna chat with their fists, though, or with their words? The kickstand bar.
And the doctor says he only has a few months to live.
That's bad news for all of us. He's not just a nice guy. He's also the last motorcycle maker in the country. What happens to Corley Motors if he dies?
Don't worry. I have a plan. And if you come to the shareholders meeting with
hey,
us,
thanks for the subscription. Sorry, the way I have it set up, I can't actually see who it was. So hey, say hi in the chat. Thanks, I can see the chat, but not the subscription banner thing. Sorry about that.
The old man says it's the Polecats or nothing.
Then I guess it'll have to be nothing.
And that's your last word?
That's it.
Well, I'd like to make you just one...
Oh, I did manage to see it. I chimed into the delayed thing. So, Gabriel Wilson, thanks for the subscription.
Bolas, take this coat and go get his motorcycle. We'll have to tie up this little 200-pound loose end.
200 pounds? He's huge. He's like 250 or something like that. The guy's huge. He's got a lot of upper body mass. When I
go. Boy, is he in for a surprise.
Hey, where's Ben going?
Your colleague has decided to accept our generous offer, after all.
No, I didn't.
Fact,
no, don't tell your lies.
Scout out the route.
He did?
Well then, let's roll 'em, boys. Yahoo! Poor Bill, here we come.
What a smackdown. Yeah, he sure beat the shit out of him. Skip dialogue, commentary. Ooh, yeah, there's like an audio commentary track, I think, from the as much of the original team as they could assemble, in mostly Tim. I don't think it's remastered commentary. I'm actually not certain. It's new to the remastered edition, though. It wasn't in the original. Highlight objects. Let me just kind of... Ooh, you got to steer your bike now and again. And walk to open, talk to people, inventory. Oh, I'm not playing with a controller, so I will just focus on the mouse controls. I should be fine. I should be able to figure this all out. But I do want to try and flip on subtitles there. That was my mistake for not having that on to begin with. Speech. Remastered. Get the remastered speech. And that's just like the... They had the original audio files that had to be compressed for the original game. And now in this one, they're able to use the original uncompressed audio files. So some people, some purists, might not be into that, but I'm here for the remastered edition. I'm looking to experience all the remastered glory. So let's stick with that stuff. Get myself a dumpster. Is that where I am? Oh, yeah. That is where I am. I'm currently in the dumpster. I like the resume button being the keys. Well, now I know exactly where I am. It just that helps me out a little bit. There you go. Good effective punching there, Ben. Man, the animation in this is really good. I need to see like a side-by-side of the original Pixel stuff and what they remade to see how much they added. Like, normally there where he's doing his little like post-dumpster stretch or whatever, or moving his arm around, did it used to be like 1, 2, 3? It's hard to see my arm, but was it like 3 frames and they added some in-betweens, or is this like... Is it all the original animation? They've just smoothed it out a little. So I really don't actually know. I don't know a whole lot about this game. Let's investigate the boxes. Oh, I can kick it, or I can grab it, or I can skull fuck it, I guess.
I'm not putting my lips on that.
I guess is that... What was it supposed to be? Is it supposed to be him eating? Oh, I can look or taste. So let's look at
They're
it.
Empty.
I didn't realize I was controlling this, and I was like, what the fuck, the set of, what is going on there? What if I grab it?
Use for those.
Yeah, there's nothing there. Take a look at it. Take a look in the dumpster.
Woken up and worse.
What kind of shit are you up to, Ben? What kind of greasy shitholes are you waking up in if you've woken up and worse than that dumpster? I want to see if I can go in, back into the kickstand. And then maybe I can find some clues or something that maybe someone left behind. Oh, okay. I didn't realize I had to kick in the door. I thought that the boot was maybe walk.
I fixed your door.
I was wondering if they were going to draw attention to that. I thought this guy would be kind of mad about that.
Just leave me out of this mess.
No, I'm dragging you into it. And also I might try to rob you if the opportunity presents itself.
I've never liked nose rings.
Me neither, but someone dared me.
So you already had 2 earrings, and then you got dared into adding a nose ring on top of it? Seems like you're a very easily manipulated person, or easily goaded into doing things. I assume this means talk in this context, not taste.
Looks like you're out of customers.
Yeah, your gang talk off with those well-dressed gentlemen. So what'll it be, Mac?
Where'd everyone head off to? I want to know who knocked me out. What do you got for a headache?
I want to know who knocked me out.
Maybe you just passed out. You should learn to handle your liquor.
I think
oh,
you're
you son of a
this
bitch.
Whole bum deal.
Yeah, well, what are you gonna do about it?
Oh, I'm gonna beat you up.
What do you have?
You're gonna wake up with a knuckle sandwich? You're not gonna. I don't know. I don't know how to be threatening. Ben, that's Ben's job. I'll leave the threatening comments to him, since that's not going to be my forte. Where'd everyone head off to?
Where'd everybody head off to?
What am I, the cruise director? Maybe they're up on the Lido deck.
Pretty proud of yourself there, aren't you,
you
dink?
Want something?
What do you got for a headache?
A little sympathy.
Thanks.
But not much.
How about I rob ya? How about I grab your register?
It's empty.
You probably shouldn't have it pointed outwards, too. Why is it pointed at the patrons rather than, you know, at the bartender? Seems a little backwards.
The monitor doesn't have any controls.
I just wanted to watch a little bit of TV.
High kicking was never my move.
I was wondering if you could kick it. Let's kick this piano. Let's rough this guy's bar up a little bit.
Play.
That's not how pianos work. You can't just kick a piano into playing. He must be an ultimate badass then. What about these cool antlers?
Those might look good mounted on my handlebars. Nah.
Nah, too tacky. How about the badger though?
Good thing that's a badger.
Why?
Cause if that were a dead polecat, I'd have to trash the place.
I actually don't know what the hell a polecat is. I didn't know that was a real animal. These are all monitors? What kind of heavily monitored bar is this?
Doesn't have any controls.
Yeah, the signal is piped in from Kickstand National Headquarters.
Well then, that's about all I can ascertain from the bar. I was thinking maybe I could get some info, a lead, some kind of item or something. Let's see what he has to say about the Kickstand bar, though.
The Kickstand.
Yep, that's about it. So let's just go for a ride then. How about we just hightail it out of here? Kicky's the answer to everything. Oh, you better believe I'm gonna kick.
Some joker took my keys.
I'm gonna kick a lot of things. Ah, shit. Are they back in the dumpster there? I would have to guess they're around back in the dumpster, maybe. Or, like, in that general area. I didn't poke around there very much. Some joker. How about the dumpster? Well, if I'm gonna be kicking things, then I might as well start off right and kick the first thing in the game. Yeah, you show him, Ben. That'll teach that dumpster to be a place where you wake up. Damn straight.
Empty and boxes.
Just more empty
you really
boxes.
You should flatten these so they can be recycled.
How environmentally conscious of you, you
yeah,
biker gang.
He can flatten his own boxes.
You want them flattened, but you're not willing to do it yourself, Ben. You got to put in a little bit of the legwork now and again if you want to make a difference in the world. You're like one of those helpful biker gangs that do fundraisers for children's hospitals and shit like that. Alright, so my keys must be in here somewhere. I just don't even know where to start looking. Picture? Take a look at some of these pictures, perhaps. Let's check out the stools.
Big fish.
Yep.
Yep. How about I boot the bartender?
No.
No. It is a little bit of a high kick, but I bet you could have done it. But it would probably be like kicking the blob from X-Men. Looks like it would just kind of get like absorbed.
You want something?
I'm looking for my keys. Oh, there we go. I didn't realize a new dialogue option would have opened up.
About.
No, come on. Be a little more helpful here, bartender.
No.
What about the smooth?
Order something?
No.
Something smooth. What happened to that option?
I never liked nose rings.
Me neither, but someone dared me.
How the heck did I lose that one option already? Let me see here. What did Tab do?
Anything.
That was looking at things. I think that's about the extent of what I can click around in for now. So let me see. Right. There's a few other places I can go outside here. I'm not totally limited to those two starting areas. But at the same time, it looks like maybe I kind of am, because this seems like it would be a little bit absurd to have to walk, like, all the way to some new areas. Let's
That's
see.
That's where I came from. Nothing that way from me but a warrant.
And
I'd never catch up to them on foot.
Okay, so you need your keys. That's kind of what I was trying to confirm here. It seemed like the way things were going was you need your keys. And now at least I know that that's the case. Check your little saddlebag. Ugh, why isn't that an option? Why can't you look there? How about you just take a quick little look at your bike?
Good thing Ripburger didn't touch my bike. Good thing for him.
So threatening. Give
Some
it a kickstart.
My keys.
Damn it. And taste
I'm not
it.
I'm putting my lips on that.
Why not? You clearly love your bike. Why not give it a quick little smooch? A quick little peck, perhaps. Aw, come on, man. piano... Search the piano? I guess I only kicked it before.
Yeah, right.
No, don't know how to play that, Ben. Apparently you can kick the hell of a piano, so no real need for the ability to play, I guess, when you can magically kick them into working. No, don't.
You gonna order something?
No.
Ah, come on.
I don't have anything.
No items to be used? Well, I certainly didn't expect to get stumped this early in the game. That is very unfortunate. Any ideas here, Josh? Where am I not looking? Where am I supposed to be looking that I'm missing right now? Maybe I can head out in this direction? I think all of these just take me to that outer map area. Yeah, so there's not a whole lot I can get to see there. And let's investigate back around here one more time.
I don't have anything.
Is there?
I don't have anything.
Look, what are the controls here? Is there? What's like my inventory? Can I just see like what I'm carrying? Switch render mode. Nope. Open menu. Object highlight. No, none of that is useful. So I'm totally stuck. I know. I was trying to kick the bartender. Apparently not a real option. I've woken up in worse. He's got all that. He's already said all that shit. Kick these stupid boxes, no. Then. Oh, you picky man. What are they just like laying around in the grass here? Maybe is you see anything there, Ben? Come on now. You gotta be more careful with your belongings. Can't just lose your shit like that. Nothing in the sign.
I don't have anything.
Can't grab the register.
It's empty.
What if I just talk about it?
My lips on that.
Or look at it.
Mm.
It's empty. Don't get any ideas.
Bottles. There's something.
Booze.
Something I hadn't been able to use before.
My lips on that.
Or well, I could. I just didn't think to. Well, take one.
Got a ride.
Damn it. Maybe you missed something. Holding shift. I can't. Holding shift, I don't know exactly. I'm doing it right now. It doesn't actually seem to do anything, so I'm not certain what holding shift actually does. Maybe it highlights items, but not just like random things that you can click around on. Oh, okay, so that is a bit different. I can look in the windows.
It's empty, but I can see the bartender in there.
Okay, so shift could be a little bit helpful. I'm not sure why it wasn't doing anything in the bar then. It made me think that it just didn't work. This is all just dumpster boxes and this other stack of boxes. I've already interacted with all that, so there's nothing to see there. Let me go out to like the upper outer world there. Holding shift out here doesn't do anything. It's not a real option. And what about back behind? Nothing. How about... I think if I double-click, I can fast travel to places. That's handy. That's annoying that I can't use shift in the bar for some reason. Maybe there's too much shit that can be clicked on? He just says that they don't work. Controls.
Yeah, the signal is piped in from Kickstand National Headquarters.
Picture I've already interacted with. Another picture.
What's this?
It's a big blobby gray shape. I was taking an art class.
The monitor doesn't have any controls.
Well, I don't know why my dialogue tree with this guy was totally cut short, but that's a pain in the ass. I can't do anything there. What the fuck? I didn't want to, like, have to look up a walkthrough, but I really don't want to be stuck on the first part of this game forever, so... Unfortunately, I'm doing it, and then hopefully once I get chugging along, I can, like... Once I get a nice groove going, I don't have to do this anymore, but this is super annoying. So I'm looking things up, because, like, what the fuck... am I supposed to do? If you try to ride your bike, you won't have your keys. The kickstand is closed, kicking the door, bartender isn't talking. What? All I had to do, I can't believe that I hadn't tried this. And further down the line, I will think harder about what I have and haven't done.
What?
The bar. Now don't mess around with me.
I can't believe I hadn't tried that. I feel so stupid.
I got your keys, but I don't know nothing. They had guns. They told me to stall you as long as possible.
Why?
I don't know. I don't know. I overheard them say something about an ambush up the road.
What else?
Hey, I have memes. Glad you could finally join the stream, buddy.
Here are your keys, all right?
Thanks for jingling them, those around for me.
Someone did say something about killing you and making it look like an accident.
They didn't do too good of a job there. But why ambush the Polecats?
That was supposed to be someone killing me and making it look like an accident? They hit me over the head and threw me in a dumpster. How will that ever in a million years look like an accident? That was the worst plan I've ever heard of. Who thought that that was going to work? That's so stupid. That's so stupid. All right, well, sorry that it took like 20 fucking minutes just to figure out how to get out of like the starting area. Now I'll be in the groove and I won't make such stupid mistakes in the future. I like his rocket-fueled bike, though. That was pretty fucking sweet.
I'm indestructible.
You may feel that way, but you should really be wearing a helmet.
But they try.
Oh, hey, Bane. I actually have never played it.
Hey, ain't you the A number one pole?
So it might be kind of cool to have someone around to, is familiar with the game in case we get horrifically stuck somewhere down the line, well, which has already happened once this stream.
When the Rottweilers hit the road, we own it.
The Rottweilers. I like their name more than ours, actually.
Ambushing the Polecats.
Someone's
His bike is big and badass, too.
Oh, heavens. Whatever will we do?
Man, you smart ass. I'll run you off the road. That's my answer to this.
Come on, kitty. Let's get down.
Ooh, do I get to race? Oh, I just punch him right in the face. I'm just going to punch him forever. It seems like I got the upper hand as long as I just do that infinitely. Yep. That was easier than expected. I just have to lean in hard and punch nonstop. Who knew I was such a badass on the road? Me, personally. Everyone knew that Ben was a badass on the road, but get a load of me here. I don't even need a wheel. I need a wheel, but I don't need two wheels. I'll be fine with just the one here. We'll just keep popping a wheelie for as long as possible. Oh, no! Terrible. Terrible, terrible, terrible. So not only did they steal your keys, but they also busted up your bike. Or maybe your bike's busted up from the battle you just took part in. Probably unrelated.
Something about killing you and making it look like an accident.
I have a plan.
They had guns.
Oh shit, he's looking awfully roughed up.
Something about an ambush up the road.
Oh, ambush up the road. Did that already happen or is it coming up? I personally already forgot about that. Very stupid to just drive right into it. Oh, maybe it's the accident up the road that they're making look like an accident, not tossing me in a dumpster, because that would never in a million years look accidental.
Man, this is gruesome.
This is Bart Simpson?
I print these in color.
Oh, okay.
Now I have to get you some help, I suppose.
Sounded a little bit Bartish, but now there's a bit of an accent on there. It doesn't really sound like Bart anymore. Creepy gas mask character here. Oh man, it would be badass if he just did a wheelie the entire way. Just never stop wheeling. You never stop your bike though. If you find that you like the game, another great one to check out from the same time period is called The Dig. Cool, thanks for the recommendation. I'll keep that in mind.
You were in an accident. A reporter found you and brought you and your bike here.
My bike? What have you done with my bike?
Brought it back from the dead. Sort of like what I did with you. I need a little help getting it finished, though.
Man, he was awfully concerned about the bike. Also, all his stuff is patched up. His face and his coat and everything. He was looking really rough a minute ago there. Who are you? How does it look? I gotta get out of this town fast. We'll start with a simple who are you?
Remember? If that's too hard, maybe you should just stick with Mo.
Do you have a last name? This is an authorized Corley Service Center? Where'd you learn bikes?
Where'd you learn bikes?
I grew up working on them with my dad. One summer we did nothing but restore this old hardtail together. I mean, we scrubbed every bolt until it shined. But he took off one day and he never came back. So I switched to toasters.
Oh, that's quite the downgrade, I'd say. People love their toast. I had toast for breakfast this morning, but repairing toasters versus repairing motorcycles? Seems like a bit of a downgrade. Do you have a last name, Mo?
I prefer not to use it. What about you?
Just Mo, same deal. Then.
Then it's Ben and Mo forever, I guess.
You don't want to use your last name? Your last name is Throttle. People should just be calling you Throttle. You should abandon your first name. It's weird that you would choose not to use it. The Dig was produced by Steven Spielberg. What? I think I've actually read up on that once, that Steven Spielberg had, like, produced a game. If not several. So that's... It blows my mind a little bit. I think I maybe have heard about that. Hey, thanks for throwing a subscription up there, Bane. Let's see, what else we got here? Is this an authorized Corley Service Center? I'm gonna go ahead and strongly guess that it isn't.
I call this a Corley Service Center, but I don't have the official paperwork.
Ah, an illegitimate Corley operation.
That's my kind of operation.
A renegade Corley operation.
You live in this town?
Well, Melonweed's not much of a town. What's left of it is sinking about a foot a year. People either learn to adjust, or they leave, which is fine with me.
Not a people person?
I'm just better with toasters, that's all. You seem more concerned with me than your bike.
Oh, maybe he's taking a fancy to Mo. And then if they got married, they wouldn't have to decide who took whose last name, because apparently they're both living the share life of no real last names. Sorry that I keep narrating the text choices. I've been playing a lot of Planescape Torment on the channel, and there's like no real voice acting there. You have to narrate it, so I'm kind of in that mindset. I'm trying to let the game do its own thing. Sorry that I'm talking over it now and again. Man, please don't talk about food. I'm getting hungry. Oh, so don't talk more about toasters and toast. And ooh, this oh-so-delicious raspberry jalapeno jam that I had. Oh, it was so good, Joshe. You could make yourself some toast. It takes like 30 seconds. How's the bike look?
It looks better than it did, but you gotta help me out. The front forks are wasted, so you'll have to get some new ones. And someone stole my welding torch. Can you believe that? I can't finish without one. And last but not least, I patched up your ruptured gas tank, but you're out of fuel and I don't have any.
Wow, that was more wrong with it than I expected. I mean, it basically exploded, so I should have expected a lot to be wrong with it, but that was like a pretty lengthy list there. How's it going? I gotta get out of this town. Where am I supposed to find all this stuff?
Where am I supposed to find all this stuff?
You can hack it, tough guy.
Where am I gonna find a new torch, fork? Where's the gas? Maybe I just figure it out myself. I'll ask her about, like, one of them. Sorry, Josh. It was too tempting to tempt you with toast.
How am I supposed to find your torch?
I don't know. Set up a dragnet. Still can't believe someone would steal my torch. Who around here would do a thing like that?
Well, I guess I should probably just look for this stuff myself. I'm assuming she's not really going to help me out with much of that. I don't have any money.
I don't have any money.
That's a good point.
Hey, this one's free. I haven't touched anything besides a toaster for so long. Getting my hands on your hog has really been a pleasure.
Well, thanks.
Don't sweat it.
You've been getting your hands all over toasters and now a little bit of motorcycle. How about a little bit of Ben? I'll let you get back to work. I better go prowling around.
Aspirin or anything.
Let's see. I probably don't want to. I'll rifle around in here a little bit at least.
Who's this?
Oh, that's me and my Uncle Pete. He took care of me after Dad split at this place he called the Mink Ranch. When he died, he left it to me.
You're a mink farmer?
Nah, that place went belly up long.
Dirty fingernails, Ben. Clean your nails.
I still go back there whenever I need to get away for a while.
What did I miss? I left for a little bit to make tea. Aw, good thinking. What kind of tea? I'm curious. I just was drinking this, like, black licorice tea earlier, and I hate black licorice, but it's, like, the tastiest tea. Weird thing. Weird tangent to take in a game about big, burly, badass motorcycle gangs. We're talking about tea. Just an almost infinite wheelie. Yeah, that's the thing. We made a getaway from the bar. The bike broke. We ended up in Mo's shop here, and Mo was helping us fix up the bike. And I'm just kind of poking around at her hoses.
This hose smells like gas.
And that's completely non-sexual, I swear. Did I take the hose? Did I not keep the hose? It looked like he was fiddling around with a hose down there for a second at least. He was reaching for something. Oh wait, I did get that. That should help me siphon, I'm guessing, is what that's for. And a gas can. So let's just take the can as well. Then we should be able to siphon some gas. But I think that's a fair guess that that's what that stuff is for.
You're not dead yet. I might still get a quote.
I heard you saved my life.
I heard you saved my life.
Yeah, but don't worry. I wasn't Lemon trying
tea.
To.
Good pick.
I was just looking for some nice roadside disaster photos and you helped.
Came out 22 years ago. I am creeping up on 25 here, so I like to know that I'm a little bit older than this game, but it did come out kind of like early enough that I wouldn't have really had access to it or anything, so these sort of early games from this era blew me by, so I'm really excited to have the opportunity to come back and play them now and like share them with people and stuff. But no harm done, Bane. There's like the staggering of like, I'm sure there's people here in the stream now who are like closer to 18 or whatever, and then I'm sitting there thinking like, oh, I'm so old compared to them, and then there's like probably somebody who's like 14 or something, and then the 18 year olds are like, oh, I feel so old. It doesn't matter. Everyone can just get together and enjoy the game together. We're all one big happy family just enjoying some motorcycles and some games. Who'd want a picture of me bleeding?
Yeah, it's creepy.
It's not the blood. It's the way you were, all twisted up like a pretzel.
Listen, I've got to stop an ambush. Was the ambush not meant for me? Oh, the ambush is probably to take out the motorcycle.
I've got
to
stop.
The guy runs the motorcycle company.
Really? Where?
This game is 5 years older than me. Oh, yeah, yeah. So I told you, we got a full spectrum going on here, just as I predicted. And it wasn't much to predict. It was kind of just a given. The likelihood of that being the case was very high. Somewhere between here and Corville.
Somewhere between here and Corville. My crew is escorting some VIPs to the Corley Motors shareholders meeting, and there's an ambush waiting for them somewhere up the road.
Yeah?
This is hard for me. I need...
Come on, man. Spit it out.
Could you give me a ride in your car? I've got to stop this ambush.
You're right. We have to get to the ambush, all right. But I'm afraid I'm without wheels at the moment.
How did you get us here?
Hitched.
Well, I'd better be going.
All right. Drive safe now.
Well, I can't. We just went over that I don't have a car. But that's... I was thinking it's really funny that this guy is, like, unable to ask for a ride in a car. He's so focused on, like,
hurt Mo's mailbox.
Being a motorcycle guy that he like cannot do it. What was this? What is this weird little patch here that is highlighted that I can't actually seem to interact with? That's very peculiar. That makes me think that it like ended up in the wrong spot or something. Let's grab that newspaper. Maybe there's something interesting there. We'll just take it. How about we just take the newspaper?
Hey! Off my paper.
Well, fuck you. I'm going to kick your paper then. And, well, I'm guessing I'm not going to find much else around here. Oh, there we go. There's the way out. A biker in a car and not even his own? Blasphemy. Yeah, I feel for Ben. I understand why he would get so upset about this. That's not where... What are you doing? Why did you moonwalk out of there? What the hell is going on? What? What kind of bullshit was that? I couldn't even see that car there. God damn you. I thought you were helping me.
Thanks for the lift. Now I got a quote for you.
Is that... Was that part of his plan? Did he do that on purpose? What kind of shady shit just went down here? First time I ever watched you stream, by the way. Yeah, when I saw your name, I was like, oh shit, I know you've been meaning to stop in for a stream, so it's cool to have you here. I think I complained about not being able to watch your streams in a while back. Yeah, I remember that. It wasn't all that long ago, but I wouldn't call it a complaint, just a wishful thinking, like a hopefulness. Well then, where can I go next? Because I gotta start looking for some of these car parts and everything. There is a lot in this area. Maybe I run back and talk to Mo and be like, what the shit is going on? Why did I just get ditched down there? Maureen?
She's got her hands all over my bike.
Jealous?
Like, yeah, a little bit.
Mo.
Hard to get her attention. Yeah, she's Ben? Busy. Didn't even know Ben could moonwalk. He's the next Michael Jackson. Well, I'm sure if Michael Jackson would have lived another 10 years or so and gone through a few more plastic surgeries, he probably would have started looking a little bit more like Ben. It's just the natural progression, really. It's easy to just imagine eventually ending up as this burly, hard-jawed, bearded, slicked-back hair, muscle maniac. It's obvious, really, when you think about it. Is there anything that she can say about the fucking girl bailing on me here? I'll let you get back to work.
Let me know if you need anything.
Alright, well I guess I'm leaving Mo B then, and I'll go investigating some of this on my own. Like this trailer over here with whatever the hell is going. A skylight? Looks like there's a fire down there.
Either someone's doing some welding down there, or we're talking about some very subcode wiring.
Boot your way down there and steal that back. Seems like they've gone ahead and stole that welding torch here. This really makes me want to play some other Tim Schafer classic games like Day of the Tentacle and Grim Fandango. You know, I actually do have the remasters of both of those games as well, and so I've been meaning to replay them, or I should say play for the first time, and I had them set aside as like something I was going to play on my own time, not on the channel, because I figured it would take a long time and I wasn't streaming as much back then. And now, at this point, it seems like it might be fun to hang on to them as potential streaming games. So, at some point in the maybe not too far future, I'll bust those games out. I guess I couldn't really say for sure. Let's kick our way right in here. Kicking our way into doors seems to work really well. Achievement unlocked, trailer trashed. I wonder if I would have grabbed the door handle if it would have been unlocked, if I really had to do that.
It's locked up with steel brackets.
Guess it's time to kick it. I guess there are some reinforced steel brackets then. The real tough kind.
I pictured him having a much larger fridge.
It's also it's just his upper cabinet here is the fridge. It's not a very big
his
fridge.
His decor has a strong carnival coin toss flavor to it.
That's what an ultimate insult.
Looks like a cabinet to me.
Well, reach on in there. See what he's got. The lockpick. Ooh, great. Oh, whoops. I keep using look instead of grab. And now if I were...
locked up with steel brackets.
There, here's what I wanted. There we go. This is the first time I've had to use an item. There we go.
Lockpick won't help there.
What? Why won't it? That seemed like a genius idea. What kind of shit you got in here? Let's take his meat. That it might come in handy. I keep just looking at things rather than trying to take them, so I gotta remember to try and take things more often. I love Day of the Tentacle. Sadly, I've never played it myself, just watched others play it. Wouldn't even surprise me if there's an achievement for kicking every door in. There might be. They added like 50 achievements to this game or something like pretty excessive like that, so they might have a lot of fun little achievements like that rather than just story progression ones.
Smells like burning metal down there.
Seems like someone's having a wedding. And by that I mean welding. Let's kick our way down there, Ben. Dang. Dang nabbit. What kind of stuff do I have? What if I just chuck some meat down there?
That's not one of meat's many uses.
Meat's many uses. What about if we chuck it right down here? I like the idea of meat having lots and lots of uses. You're gonna walk all the way around just to tell me that it's not one of meat's...
That's not one of meat's many uses.
God damn it, Ben. Come on, buddy. You gotta help me out here. Take a look at his sandbags, maybe?
Probably all that's holding this dump up. It's even sadder looking inside.
Well, I think that's about everything I can do in and around here. How do I get down? The sandbox. Oh, I meant to kick the sandbox, because for some reason I had it in my mind that maybe I could kick it apart and find a secret entrance or something.
No thanks. This sandbox has been taken over by a big dog.
What if I threw meat into the sandbox?
That's not one of meat's many uses.
It didn't seem like it would be a real thing, but I thought maybe it would be worth checking. How do I possibly get down there? Let's see. Let's take a nice look from the outer perspective here. I don't think there's anywhere to try and enter. There's some far further off places. Like if I went to here. Yeah, see, this is very, very different. I'll probably need the piece of meat for the junkyard. That seems like a classic. A real classic. Can you just grab it?
In the glass.
Not a chance.
I'm not putting my lips on that.
No, I want you to shout. You gotta learn the difference between talking and kissing or eating, Ben. You're making this harder on yourself than you need to. Maybe there's some secret way of getting somewhere in here that I missed. I got a lockpick. And yeah, I can't see there being much else I need to do around here, so maybe I need to come back to it. I'll take a step away. I'll go to the junkyard. Maybe we'll come back to there. Let's take a look at the rolling door here.
Heavy looking.
Probably can't lift it. Alright, just give it a punch. Oh, Todd's junkyard. I guess this is the same Todd, because it said it had like Todd's scrapyard signs or whatever inside of the house there. Seems to be no real options there. And ooh, there's a rope that can be climbed. I don't know if using the shift thing is like cheating, because presumably something like that didn't exist in the original game, so it feels like I'm getting like secrets, cheats a little bit. I feel like he's gonna let go and it's gonna close again. I think there's something in the dresser. Oh, I'll have to go back and take a look then. Thank you for the tip, I do appreciate that. Right, so he does need to hold it here somehow. Be right back, see if I have any food in my home left. sorry I put all that temptation out there. Ah, nuts.
Hose won't help here.
I thought maybe you could have tied it up. It was worth a shot, I suppose. For half a second out here, it looked like he didn't have his welding station set up. It's all turned out, so I thought that maybe he had quit welding for a second there. But alas, it looks like he's still at it, still using his damn stolen welder. Right, in this dresser, right? This is the one that I tried to lockpick, but apparently can't. Which I really thought.
A lockpick won't help there.
Which, why not? Why can't? What, you're not gonna try? I'm gonna try, buddy. Yeah, I seem to not be able to.
It's locked up with steel brackets.
Yeah, all my kicks and stuff don't seem to help, so I must be missing an item. Did I miss anything in the cabinet? No. Hey, cool, I can hear loons. Loons are like a common thing to throw into games, despite the fact that they're like not that widespread. You hear them in like a desert-based game that you're definitely not going to hear a loon in. Well, I'll go take a look at this big whatever it is then. Ooh, this might be something I can lockpick then. A lock is what the thing is. Tough looking. Well, you're tougher, Ben. I don't want to hear you saying you can be out-toughed by anything. Achievement unlocked. Not so tough after all. Yeah, in fact, it was quite easy, so that worked out spectacularly, I'd say.
I bet that thing's full of gas. If only I could get in there.
Well, you're in luck, Ben, because I found a way in, and it was quite easy. Weird assumption that it would be full of gas. Could be full of a lot of things, really. Oh, this highlights, but I can't actually seem to interact with it. Oh, there we go. If I do it just right, Oh, come on, I had it highlighted for half a second there. I can't remember how to open the dresser, but I think it's an elevator. Okay, yeah, that would make sense. I do need some way to get down. I'm not sure. Am I crazy that I thought I highlighted that for a second? Let's just go run up the ladder instead, I suppose. Or don't look at it, Ben. Use it. We'll use the ladder. Oh, shit. I wasn't expecting this. I don't know what to do. Use the meat. Use the meat, Ben. Fuck, is there guard dogs coming for me or something now? Oh god, this is worse than I thought. I thought it was just gonna be dogs and I would throw some meat to distract them. What am I supposed to do? Was I supposed to run? Did I have a window of time where I could possibly have ran? No, I swear I'm not. Your lock was just really shitty. Oh god, they're opening fire? What? Wow, I shoot on sight, I guess. Hopefully they leave and that alarm goes off. Seems like they're clearing out. Okay, so that's not how you do that. I do want to go back there and I'll just, you know, try to be a little more careful. Maybe I can take this lock. Hey, of course, of course. They always have things like that in these types of games where it's like an item has multi uses. Alright. Can I combine...
A gas can won't help here.
I just wanted to combine those things. Can't seem to use that. I probably need to deactivate something in order to gain any kind of access to that. So let's just hop on out of here, Ben, why don't we? And we'll go take a look elsewhere. Let's try around the house here again. Didn't really get a chance to fully look around. Empty. Especially when that car took off, I was thinking that maybe there might have been something that the car left behind. And this weird little bit that highlights here is messing with me, but I don't really think that it's anything. Maybe I will ask Mo a little bit about, like, where things are. Her general answer seems to be like, I don't know, but that's about as good as my own answer is, too, so any little bit of info might help. I'm having trouble finding some stuff.
Trouble finding stuff.
What's the problem?
That run cycle was beautiful. I would almost be tempted to let it play out again, but... That little cutscene of the police officers coming in their hover car for some reason took a little while to play out. Oh, some new forks.
Where am I gonna find new forks?
Well, they don't have to be new, just not broken into little pieces. You could start by asking Todd in the trailer across the way. He runs the junkyard.
And gas?
Where's the gas?
Well, there's a whole tower full of it at the edge of town. I have this crazy, irrational intuition that tells me maybe it's worth checking out.
Well, thanks for your sass, Mo. I was coming to ask about items, not sass.
Still can't believe someone would steal my torch. Who around here would do a thing like that?
Actually, I think I can handle it.
Turns out it's your best buddy, Todd, who you're super excited about.
I gotta get out of this town, fast.
Trouble with the law?
Not in this county.
Then what's the hurry?
My gang's in trouble.
Polecats.
How'd you know that?
Big emblem on the back of your jacket.
They're headed for an ambush, so I gotta catch them.
We better get this bad boy back on the road then, huh?
I just kind of never went down the full dialogue track for Mo, and I just didn't unlock an achievement for it. It's called No Mo. No, like K-N-O-W. So now I know a little bit more about Mo. Wait, but if I need the welder to open the dresser, and the dresser is the elevator that helps me get down to where the welder is, they don't quite seem to match up. We're putting the cart before the horse here. Oh, I have pages of stuff. There we go. Now I can view some of this other shit. I can probably lock this. So if I grab this, yank it down, I can probably use the lock to hold that in place. And let's see here, bust out the lock and chuck her on there. Oh, that made so much
sense.
That's
not something I want to lock.
Why don't you want to lock it? That was such a genius idea. That made so much sense to me. Why? How could you not make that work? Come on. Come on, Ben. You gotta be smarter here. You gotta work with me. I thought, that seemed too good. Too good. Alright, what else do I have? A gas can, a hose. None of that's gonna help me with that, so I can't make use of any of that shit. There's gotta be a way down here, No, I've already tried this. I've already tried to throw meat down there. I'm just trying to think of some way to, like, get him out. Maybe? That's not gonna work, though. None of that is going to do it. I think I got everything back at Maureen's. It's hard to know 100% for certain, but it really seems like I did. It wouldn't make sense to use a lock on a locked cabinet.
That's not something I want to lock.
But I thought I would try. This has got to be everything from inside the actual trailer. I think I've got all of that figured out. Nothing that would make sense in a sandbox, I don't think. Sandbags. What could I possibly do with the sandbags? Maybe I could tear them open or something? That didn't make a lot of sense, but I thought I would try it. What if I get some sandy meat?
That's not one of meat's many uses.
I'm just trying to slap things together now at this point. Yeah, I think Maureen's welder is down this hole here that I'm trying to get to. What else could I have maybe done here? I've done all that. I've broken in here. Still can't figure out how to interact with this little silo thing on the side here. Maybe I have to turn off this spotlight somehow. If I step over here, do I get all lit up? Is that why I get caught? I wouldn't say any of that.
Won't help here.
None of that seems particularly helpful. I can't use the hose on there. Can't use the hose on that. I'm getting stuck again. I heard the puzzles in this game were tricky, but I wasn't expecting to get quite so stumped. But I might just be bad at these point-and-click adventure games, maybe. I don't think there's anything outside here that I've missed. I got everything up in Moe's shop, to the best of my knowledge. Shit, I'm just running in circles here. Not gonna find anything just ducking in and out of random crap like this. Is there some area that I haven't visited? I think I've been everywhere I can go. Let's see, I think you have to hide behind the background thing after those guys come. Oh, because there's a little window. There's a little window of time that I have there. That would make sense. I was wondering why it gave me a little window of time. And I even said in the stream, like, oh shit, do I have to, like, run out of here? Like, do I have enough time to flee? And I accidentally walked him back behind here at one point. Shit, that's gotta be how I do that part. So at the very least, I can get some gas, I think. Good thinking, Bane. Thank you for the help there, because I was getting awfully stuck. It's so stupid that I had the different pieces of that in place. I went up the ladder, I realized that I had time to run and do something. I accidentally had even gone behind the thing at one point, and somehow it didn't all add up to the obvious solution here.
I don't see nobody. He must have run away.
Nah, we would have seen him running from the air. He must be hiding up in the tower.
We got him treed.
Let's go up and get him.
Oh shit, maybe I can rob some things from their vehicle here then. Get in there, man. The hover sled, take a look at it. I want to hear what you have to say about this thing. It's got like a lifeguard tower on it and stuff.
I don't trust anything without wheels.
Okay, he's got his wheelbase life.
Without wheels.
How about kick
don't
it.
Don't touch anything without wheels.
Not even gonna kick it? Oh, but you can probably hook up a hose.
A hose won't help. A gas can won't help here.
It's weird how bits and pieces come back to me while watching. Yeah, it's pretty funny. I thought for sure I was gonna siphon gas out of this thing. Maybe I'll lock it up.
Something I want to lock.
Maybe I'm supposed to head up there after these guys. Now that they're separated from their thing? Oh, come on, really? Shit. Well, I can't think of what else I could possibly be doing to this then. Not gonna put your lips on that, are you, Ben?
I'm putting my lips on that.
You're not gonna touch it, you're not gonna look at it. What the hell will you do? Throw some meat on it?
That's not.
That doesn't make sense.
A lockpick.
I thought for sure I was gonna siphon gas out of this thing. Now I definitely don't know what I need to do.
A hose won't help here.
Ah, shit.
I don't touch anything without wheels.
Not willing to do any of that, huh? Well, are those guys gonna be busy? Is one of them Todd or something? Is Todd suddenly no longer at his place? That doesn't seem like how that would work, but... Or maybe the junkyard is suddenly free? No, none of that really made sense. Didn't really think that would be the case. Okay, at least this looks like it's sticking around. I've got some time to figure out an option here. I don't have to run through the whole rigmarole of it again if I don't figure it out right away here. I need the gas from the tower, so I guess that's obviously not what I'm trying to do here. But I thought maybe I would be stealing the forks off of this thing, or getting something off of it. And I can't go up the ladder. What if I kick it? I can't trap them up there?
I'm not putting my lips on.
Is all you have to say? I really thought you would have something helpful to say here. Well then. That really doesn't seem to help me out here. What it might have done is freed people up from the junkyard, so if I get into the junkyard, I don't think you're clicking on the gas tank. Is there? Oh, no. Pump it. Pump the gas up. Oh, cool. I like your accordion-style gas can. That's very neat. But it would be much more helpful to put gas in it first before you pick it up again. Maybe I just gotta... Can you need to put your mouth on S, obviously. So once again, I knew what needed to be done, but I knew it 40 minutes ago or half an hour ago or something. I didn't know it now all of a sudden.
Good. You get this from the gas tower?
Not exactly.
And once we get a welding torch and some new forks, I can fix her up.
Well, alrighty, we got one thing taken care of. Let's see what else we maybe got waiting for us then. I'm getting a little more limited on my items.
Not something I want
to lock. I got the gas at least. Maybe if I go back there, something will have been like left behind. I can't climb the tower because the guys will just come back and that's not going to do me any good. So that's feeling like that's everything I can do in that particular screen. So I'll move on from there, I suppose. The junkyard. Locking is not going to do anything. There's junkyard dogs around, presumably.
That's not one of meat's many uses.
Okay, what if I yank the chain, open it up, and then, like, throw the meat or something like that to coax some dogs out, maybe? It's a stretch, but... Nope, not, Well, what if I grab the chain and then use the meat on the chain to get a dog over here? I'm not sure if these ideas make sense. It's not a good idea.
That's not one of meat's many uses.
The game's background art is so pleasing to look at. It actually does look great. The updates they made to it turned out fantastic. I'm not as familiar, like I don't really know the original art, very well or at all, aside from some like screenshots, so I can't fully compare it, but I think they did a really good job. And you got to keep in mind that normally it would be cut off like here and here. This is all stuff that they were able to add with the remastered edition, so it turned out looking really, really good. I didn't look in this one window, but I don't think that would make a difference.
Looking inside.
Yeah, he's just commenting on how it's a bit of a shithole. Play in the sand?
No thanks. This sandbox has been taken over by a big dog.
Did I try and throw meat in here? I swear that
it's
I did.
Not one of meat's many uses.
Mm-hmm. Well, let's just boot our way back into here. I feel like I've done everything in this room. What else? What could I have missed? I already looked at the signs.
His decor has a strong carnival coin toss flavor to it.
And I've tried the chest. Give Mo a quick revisit here. I've investigated her mailbox plenty of times. She'll probably just tell me that she's hard at work.
Mo.
Yeah, Ben?
Well, I'll let you get back to work.
Let me know if you need anything.
I always love that in point-and-click adventure games. People are like, hey, how's it going? What's up? And then they're like, oh, hey, Ben, haven't seen you in a while. All right, see you later. Good talking to you, Ben. No one's ever like, what the hell? Can you lock the junkyard door? I've tried to lock the chain. I'm not sure if I've tried to lock the door itself. Oh, if I lock the door, then the chain won't move. So then he can just, like, climb the chain rather than it opening the door? I've tried to lock everything. I was trying to lock fucking sandboxes and shit. Ooh, I like that music there.
Junk.
Beautiful, glorious junk. Everyone's favorite. Let's take a look at what we got here. Oh, there's gonna be a dog. Oh, this was a stupid idea. I should have used the meat. I should have used meat to protect myself.
Forget about it.
What about if I just toss this meat down somewhere? Lots of junk. Oh, and this one looks like it has what I need. So let me see if I maybe throw down some meat there to distract.
That's not one of meat's many uses.
But if I rummage in this parts pile, I bet I can find what I need. Yeah, I was kind of expecting that this ravenous junkyard dog might be around here somewhere. I mean, I got the meat for it.
Meat dogs.
It's not a lot of things that you like, are there? Is he just gonna end up back in that same exact pile? Well, let's get down there and let's find a good place to plant the meat. If you stick it here, perhaps?
Dog jumps.
Oh, whoops. That was an accident.
Dog jumps in car, eats meat, jumps out, kills me.
I thought that was great. I thought that was all we needed. It seemed like the plan was perfected at that point.
Cars, no thank you. Cars, no thank you.
Oh, good. There is a little bit more here to explore. I was wondering if it would keep panning over for me. Oh, shit. Well then. Ah!
Junk.
No. Oh, you don't have to run all the way back, do you? So much running. Where could I have placed the meat?
Down.
Maybe I gotta do something to the meat. Maybe I gotta get, like, sleeping pills in there or something. But now is the dog distracted over there doing his other stuff? If I just run over there, he's not going to be hiding in the parts pile a second time, is he? So I should just be able to rummage around in there, freebie? You're too good at what you do, dog. absolutely vicious. But it seemed like maybe I could have weaved my way through those cars, that little lineup of cars there, doing like the physical kind of movement style puzzle solving like that doesn't really seem like something that would go along with this style of game, but it might be the answer here. Ah, fuck. I'm starting to think that that's not how I'm supposed to get through that. Sorry guys, I got a quick message I need to check on here. Could be important. So I am kind of waiting on a semi-important message. And
needs dogs.
Not anything that needs answering right now. What could I do? Throwing meat in the pile's not gonna do anything.
That's not one of me.
I can't lockpick the car, although I don't really see a need to.
A lockpick won't help there.
No, I didn't think so. Didn't particularly think so. There's only the junk pile, the car, and the parts pile. Seems like there's something I ought to be doing here.
Here, Poochie Pooch. Pooch.
What?
Bon appetit, mate.
Did I just get him? I got him trapped in one of these junked up cars? Why was there so many junk cars there? I won't ask too many questions. It looks like it worked out for me, so let's move on and go grab those parts we needed. Do a quick pick and pull. Get ourselves some useful motorcycle forks and spoons and other cutlery. No! That didn't work? That was not a permanent fix? I got you trapped inside of a thing. I still have the meat, right? I'm not permanently down a piece of meat, am I? Shit. That would be kind of bullshit. Oh, what? I don't have that meat anymore? Well, if I go back over there, can I fucking somehow trap that dog in there? Like, I got the... Is he gonna go right back into the car again? That'd be kind of stupid, but maybe. Kick it? No! Why? Stupid! Alright, maybe I gotta do something with some of the other cars. Seems weird that there's so many junked up cars to interact with. Oh god, there's a skull on the ground! At the base of that dog's foot. That looked like a skull to me, at least. That's kind of gruesome. I swear his run cycle must have been a lot of fun to animate, and sorry I won't be able to help you with any of the puzzles. Ah, you can always pitch suggestions. Cause right now I'm struggling a little here. I managed to, this seems like the first step in what I needed to do, but damn it, I wasn't even it's a different car. I was trying to interact with a different car to try something else out. Okay.
Down. Need dogs.
What I want to do is just jump on top of the crushed car. So it like pinches the metal or whatever and creates like a pinch point that the dog can't get out of. Seems like a good solution to me, just totally trap the dog. Ben says who needs dogs anyways, so let's just get him out of there. No more dogs. Be done with it. Before you click on the red arrow to go to the part with the trapped dog, there's a red arrow that points up as well. Well, let's go check on that. Red arrow that points up. I can investigate the wrecks.
Cars. No, thank you.
But I don't seem to be able to go up. Maybe I need to go in this area and then up? It doesn't seem like there's much I can do here. Ah, shit, now I just triggered the dog again. I can't seem to find it, like, I'm guessing you mean that area right here that I'm running away from. That there's an up arrow there? Red arrow that points up.
Down. Bad dog.
It's an embarrassing number of times I've let that play out. Further to the top right. Hey Max, how's it going, man? Welcome aboard. We're just trying to work our way out of this junkyard here. Oh, I see, I see. I was trying to click along in the ground area, way up in the top right. Oh man, I'm gonna go operate like the car compactor, the trash compactor, is that what I'm doing here? Oh fuck. Yeah. Do it. Whatever the initiate button is. That's the one. Do it. Up. Down. Yes, down. There we go. Now we're cooking with gas. And let's crank that up a few times and really get this dog trapped. There, that's gotta be it, right? Oh no, shit, I didn't wanna let go of it. I wanted to keep that trapped in there. I was just trying to exit it. What did I miss? Oh, all kinds of things. I'm a part of a biker gang, the Polecats. And there is some guy who's like the last motorcycle manufacturer in the States, and him and his crooked business partner, the motorcycle manufacturer guy's good, his partner's bad, the bad guy knocked me out, left me in a trash can, made off with my gang as escorts, and they're heading towards some sort of ambush, and so my bike got trashed. I'm trying to fix my bike so that I can get out of here and go try and help. Go lend a hand to that old situation. Now it looks like I got that dog trapped up there. I gotta find the forks for my motorcycle, some gasoline, and oh, and my friend who saved me after my motorcycle crash. I'm trying to find her welder. And so we just got the gas, about to get the forks, and then
nice forks.
Now where I still gotta find her welder.
Right next to the knives and spoons.
I made that joke. I already made the cutlery joke. You're stealing my bit here, Ben. I'm here, I'm awake. Hey, Mr. Bardoth, Barda. How you doing, buddy? Glad to have everyone on board here. Now we got all the meeting of the minds. People can work together to help me out with solving some of these puzzles and everything. I've been running for about an hour, but I've got stuck for a few times, so I honestly don't know how far into the game I've made it so far, and I'm going to go ahead and say probably not particularly far. Maybe, though. We have solved a handful of puzzles. The last one remaining that's really causing me some major issues is getting down to this welder here. Can't seem to figure that one out. This guy clearly stole Moe's welder. He's down there using it.
I'm not putting my lips on that. Either someone's doing some welding down there, or we're talking about some very sub-code wiring.
But I can't actually get down there. Not certain how to get down there at all. Maybe you can just shout down there, try and get his attention.
Hello?
I thought maybe that might actually have led somewhere. Ah, good. Long day. Was taking an extended nap. Yeah, I hear you. I finally am caught up on sleep for the first time in like a week or something. I feel refreshed. I've been tired for so excessively long. It feels nice. Feels nice to have those kind of breaks.
Smells like burning metal down there.
Yeah, he's definitely welding. Give it a kick. Fuck him. I feel like that's not the first time I've kicked it. Oh. Oh, I thought maybe he heard it and stopped welding for a second. I don't know if I've tried to pick up one of these sandbags. Maybe I can do something with that to mess up his trailer. Yeah, that's a good thing. That's what I'm trying to do, Ben. I'm trying to mess up this guy's trailer here.
They'd just fall apart. I'm not putting my lips on that. Probably all that's holding this dump up.
Yeah, that's why I was trying to kick him, man. That was my whole thing. That was what I was trying to do.
Locked, but flimsy looking.
Is it still locked? Because that's like the eighth time I've kicked that guy in. Cut the wires leading in? Maybe. I don't really have anything that works for cutting. I think I've opened everything in this guy's house. The drawer. This thing's locked.
It's locked up with steel brackets.
I got the piece of meat from up in the refrigerator. I got the lockpick from this cabinet. I used the lockpick at the gas station. I used the meat at the junkyard. I think that's everything I can do in this trailer. Doesn't seem like I can actually interact with the wires themselves. The sand pit doesn't actually seem to do anything. I'm not sure if I can do anything with that. And the only item I have right now is this lockpick. You can't pick your way down there, can you? That wouldn't make a lot of sense, but maybe.
A lockpick won't help there.
Yeah, I thought not. Yep, totally. Totally stuck, I'd say. I need that welder. I think I've visited all of these now. Can I reclimb, go back into the junkyard? I don't think there's any real need for me to go back into the junkyard, but there's like a small off chance that I missed something. Let's see. But he's just going to say his whole thing about how he doesn't like cars, probably. Mr. Motorcycle.
Ooh, fire damage. Forget about it.
Forget about it. Not a fan of cars. Anything else in the parts pile? That's so unlikely.
Junk.
Yeah, didn't really see that cars. Actually panning out.
Oh, thank you.
I got that dog trapped.
Junk.
Okay, so all the cars are just junk. Not a whole lot of anything. Car?
One ill-tempered mongrel.
How long will you be streaming? I was aiming for like 3 hours. And so I've been going for about an hour and a half. I was aiming for three. I'm really not making a lot of progress here. At least it seems like I'm not. Maybe I secretly am, and I just, you know, I don't have a very good concept of how long this game actually is, or where I am in the game at this point. So who knows? Have you tried knocking on the door of the trailer? That would be preposterous. Who would knock on the door? Who would knock on an entrance? No way. Are you kidding me? All I had to do was knock? Now I'm kicking my way in here, you fat slob. Oh my goodness. Oh, good. Good one, Bane. Really helping us through here. Todd, you fat slob.
Who defines true beauty? I think he's had enough. I'm not putting my lips on that.
Not putting my lips on that. Achievement for trying to put my lips on a man. Yeah, let's crawl down into his little elevator shaft then, shall we? God damn. I immediately kicked in his door. I never thought to try and knock. I can't believe how... Oh, makes me feel so stupid.
I hope you're not trying to bring these to life or anything like that.
They do look kind of like weird-ass robots, don't they?
Not a bad version, really. That would make a good mailbox post in hell.
In hell?
I don't collect art. And I also don't collect whatever that is.
I was thinking, like, wow, good for you for considering that art, acknowledging that it might some people might like that stuff.
That's my welding torch.
Oh, I should have investigated a little bit more in the trailer before just grabbing and going what I needed, but
outside for a minute and I'll finish her up.
Probably nothing else in there worth grabbing.
I hate surprises.
It's like coding. The simplest answer is usually the right one. That's actually a very good lesson. Absolutely. I hear you on that one. I'm actually working on like an adventure type game right now. Not this style of point and click, but a lot of item swapping and matching and stuff.
Average everyday pre-regulation destroyer class solid fuel recoil booster.
You're serious?
Yes.
But only the vultures.
I have my connections. Now, are you going to try this thing out or not? Ooh, wish I had a camera.
I wish I had some way of paying you back.
Just beat it, will ya? You're scaring away my regular customers.
Bye, Mo.
Send me a postcard from the ambush.
So simple in hindsight, so difficult when you're trying to figure it out. Absolutely. Yeah, and that's part of the thing I was thinking with the game I'm working on, is there's so many little things. Oh god, we're burning down her shack. What are you doing? What have you done? Yeah, no wonder I just get a squinty-eyed like, that motherfucker just burnt down my shed. Yeah, working on that game though, it is impossible to tell if the ideas that you have are straightforward or difficult or not. You really need to sit people down in front of it and see if they're able to figure it out on their own. I've spent days and days trying to find a spelling error. Right, oh, that's fine. Fucking brutal. The little bit of programming I've tried to do myself, I've just had to like restart before. I spent like 2 weeks away from it, came back to it, and was like, I have no idea what I was doing or what I was trying to do. And I wasn't that far into it anyways, and I was like, rather than trying to figure this out, I might as well just restart everything. Well, I got my bike back. Now where to? Oh no, go back to the bike. I want you to stay on your bike. Well, I feel like I kind of half missed what was going on there. It seemed like, so I tried to ride my bike out. Sorry guys, I'm playing through this again. And there was just like police officers or stuff waiting up ahead of me. Hoping to get a clue here. That's not helpful. Just shows that there's a bunch of guys waiting for me. That's not, I don't know how to get past that. Well, Mo.
Nah, I've already said my goodbyes.
I was hoping Mo would have some ideas for me. There was a blockade, I think. Yeah, so I gotta see if there's something I can do to get around all that. I didn't really get a chance to fully investigate down here, so maybe there's a little something. This weird kitty cat? Tin dog.
I had a dog with a funnel on its head when I was a kid.
You did you? That's peculiar. I think you'll finish in your 3-hour time frame. I'm pretty sure you're only, like, a fifth of the way through so far. I was gonna do 3 hours today, and then 3 hours in another day or two, and hopefully try to, like, you know, get through the entirety of the game across that.
Least offensive of show.
Well, that seems like about all I got to see here, so I'll leave you alone, Todd. I'm surprised how quickly I got my motorcycle back and then ditched it again. I really assumed I would be dedicating more time to motorcycling around to some different places. Doubt there's gonna be anything there. I don't think you'll finish. No, it wasn't supposed to be. Wasn't supposed to be 3 hours of finishing the game in that time. Because I'm picturing at least 2 different streams to cover this game, potentially. Like having it be split between 2. Hey, oh, okay. Here's a different way.
The other way.
Well, maybe avoid the ambush then. How about you go a way that's not where the ambush is? Does that seem like an idea? Does that seem like that gels with you, Ben? Does that sparkle with you at all? Nuts. Well, if I can't get past there, I'm still just rocking a lockpick. Can't go with the blockade. Let's try to go back here, I suppose. That's an awful long way to run for presumably a whole lot of nothing. I don't really expect anything to be here. That's annoying that it made me run all that way. You can double click to like speed travel between things. Didn't seem to be working. I'm gonna try and climb this goofy ladder now that maybe all that's out of the way. Nope.
Hear that? Ah. He's back at the gas tower.
Boom.
Got a lot of nerve, that piece of trash. Let's get him. All units, follow me.
There we go, we just had to coax them away from there. That made sense. Maybe I can just hightail it out of there. Oh, good, yeah, he's already making his way out then. I'm back, made some grilled cheese sandwiches. Good call. Always a delicious treat. I've got my motorcycle back together, as you see, and I've distracted the guards, taken off on my own.
Ben,
caught back up with my gang.
Wear the suits.
Corley's making a pit stop. He has a bladder the size of a thimble, man.
Ripburger?
Haven't seen him in a while. Ben, man, what's the deal? Did you find something up the road? Are we headed for trouble?
No. We're in it.
Put my head in a basket, 'cause I'd had a tank full. When she blew my gasket, I surely was thankful.
When you say she blew your gasket, I assume you're not talking about your motorcycle there.
It's a woman with wheels that I love. Yeah.
Come on, old man. I gotcha. Now, do something incriminate, like ambush somebody.
I thought she had a sniper pointed on him or something. Oh, God. That was aggressive. Holy shit. Oh, God. You probably just killed that old man.
Me in those board meetings, Malcolm.
What a psycho.
Gotcha. Hey, look what I found in the bushes.
There's a lot of space between that guy's nose and his mouth.
It's a chokehold. Come here and I'll demonstrate.
It's got a camera. I'll get her.
No.
Ooh, clever move.
You have an important engagement with the rest of the Corley family.
Right.
But don't forget to destroy that camera.
Yeah, yeah.
Maybe just do it right away if you care so much about it.
How about one for the road?
Corley? Corley?
He's dead? You're gonna bash him again?
Ben! I guess Rip Burger couldn't wait for natural causes. Just like him to hit a man when his fly's down.
Man, pulling my fly up for me there, Ben.
Yeah, he knew I was dying, and he knew that my will would put him out of a job. He wants to take over Corley Motors, Ben. Sell it off to foreigners, lay off workers, start making minivans. You understand me? Minivans.
Oh. We're not going to have any of that, Corley. You can count on me.
Promise me, you'll hurt him bad.
I promise.
I want my daughter to take over the company.
You have a daughter?
Yeah, and she's a real mechanical genius, Ben.
Is it Mo? Mo Corley?
She was four. I used to call her the diaper dynamo. Find my daughter, Ben. Find Maureen.
Oh, okay, I was going to say a name. A name would be helpful here, man. No. Ooh, nice. You got yourself a trap door. Kind of.
Ripburger's way ahead of me.
I'm not gonna, like, investigate the scene of the crime or talk to any of my comrades or anything.
Gun, I understand. Why'd he bring a camera? Who does this guy work for? Corley Motors.
Nestor, what's that moving over there by that pile?
I don't know, Rip, but I think that
this guy's voice kills me.
Yes, now I remember. You're the smart one, aren't you?
There's Mo's shack, but I don't see the limo.
You're too late, Ben. You should have been more reckless with your motorcycling.
Looks like someone searched this place in a hurry. Nothing left but debris, except for that smashed up camera. Back's open. No film inside. Mo said she didn't have a camera. Here's Mo's picture of her and her Uncle Pete at his mink ranch. She said she went there whenever she needed to get away for a while. That's pretty much my only lead right now.
That's funny that they specifically included the thing about not having a camera. I didn't think about that being, like, significant in any way. It was smart. Smart to include that. Good writing, I would say. Yeah, I don't think there's anything to see there. Just making off towards the ranch seems to be, like the thing to do.
Looks like someone searched this place in a hurry. Nothing left but debris, except for that smashed up camera.
Alright, you've been over that part. I guess we're off to the ranch? El Rancho Luna? Yeah, alright, we're allowed to go this different way this time, so I suppose this would be us making our way up to the ranch. How's those grilled cheese working out for you, Josh? Was that the right decision? It's basically like toast. It's basically like multiple toasts plus cheese. Can't really go wrong with that, can you? A semi.
Joker's mine.
Because he drives a semi? Do you just hate wheels that much that the more wheels that anything has, the more that you hate it? Yeah, give it a few good quicks. Quick kicks.
Look, I really need a ride.
Oh, this is the kickstand. I hadn't realized I had moved back to the kickstand here. Oh!
Hey, killer.
What?
Hey, it's cool. Your secret's safe with me.
What secret?
Haven't you been watching the news?
Once again, our top story tonight, Malcolm Corley, owner of Corley Motors, was found dead at a rest stop just outside the town of Melonweed. Apparently, the benevolent patriarch and CEO was viciously beaten about the head and neck, savagely and without mercy. Police have arrested.
How many different ways are they gonna describe how violent it was?
The Polecats.
No.
With the exception of their leader, who is still at large. Roadblocks have been set up along Highway 9 in an effort to apprehend this dangerous and violent criminal.
We've been set up.
Roadblocks suck.
I shouldn't have left the game.
That's all you had to take away from that?
About it.
There's a murderer standing across from me? I hate roadblocks.
Just lay low, man.
Wow, weird that I would kind of beat you up earlier. Maybe that's why he's letting me lay low, is that I beat him up earlier. I'm gonna make myself some more tea as I wait for my BF to come back from work. That's a shame. How long until that then? Maybe the timing of the stream and the return from work will line up well for ya. Let me see. This guy might have a bit more to say.
Look. Let me tell you what happened.
I told you I don't want to get involved.
Well, fuck you then.
Look, let me tell you what happened.
I was wondering if I could yank him down by the nose ring again. Fine, I'll leave you to it, man. I'll go talk to Emmett's Beardy McEmmett over here. Stabby McEmmett.
He doesn't look happy.
Dude, he looks like he really fucking hates his hand. He's just angry at his hand. I can do that.
Not gonna happen.
Let me show you how to do that. Seems to have a lot of time in your hand. That your truck in front.
Let me show you how to do that.
Not gonna happen.
I feel like I gotta be able to challenge him to this or something and really go for it. Apparently not a real option. I've done the knife game before, but only with like blunt things. I've never tried to do it with an actual knife because that's stupid and I don't want to cut my fingers off. But when you get like a good rhythm going, if you've been practicing for a while, you can get going really fast. But it's kind of fun. Definitely done it a few times. Everyone over there just dreaming about tea? Everyone's just all super excited about drinking some tea? Now you guys are making me want tea, but I don't want to go run off and make tea. I'll have it later. I'll put off my tea time. Seems they have a lot of time on your hands.
Seems they have a lot of time on your hands. Not to mention nicks and scratches. Am I distracting you?
That's a weird reaction. Didn't say anything, just made a super silly face. That your truck out front?
Out front. I need a ride.
I look like a cabbie to you. Get lost. They're not letting anyone through that roadblock anyway.
Not even truckers?
They turned me around and said police business only, pigs.
You goddamn police officers trying to catch a murderous criminal. Dude, no ripping on the tee. I wasn't riffing on the tea. I was just saying I wish that I had tea right now. Like, legitimately. I wish I had some. Let me show you how to do that. I have no clue when his workday is over long distance and stuff. It sucks. Oh, yeah, that is rough. I've never done the long distance thing myself. Never had to, luckily, so I can't totally relate, but I have had roommates who have done it, and I do know that it is tough, so hopefully I'll just keep you company in the meantime. We'll all hang out together. Tea and biscuits, indeed it does. Look, need a ride. I really need a ride.
Not gonna happen.
Why? Because you're afraid of some cops?
No, because I don't like you.
Well, let me show you how to do the knife thing then.
Not gonna happen.
Well, then I'm going to tell you that he killed a guy.
He just killed a guy.
I'm just about to.
I don't think that's good for the table.
That's good for the table.
Hey, Quahog.
Yeah, Emmett?
I'm gonna be knifing up your table for a while, all right?
The customer with the knife is always right.
Well,
I'll show you how to do that.
Not gonna happen.
How can I coax this guy into letting me play some knife games with him?
Friendly folks you get in here.
Damn, it's not what you'd call an I'm okay, you're okay person.
Ah, shut your hole, Quahog.
What about if I get some tunes going? Maybe then you'll want to play knife games with me. Were you not impressed? Are you not impressed by my jukebox kicking powers? Probably just the same news about
members
all this.
Members of the Polecat gang are in custody, but their leader remains at large. Authorities have issued an all-points bulletin.
They got the Polecats.
Dang, son. Well, help me out here, Quahog.
Look, let me tell you what happened.
I told you, I don't want to get involved.
I was looking to just get a knife or something. Maybe I'll just grab it from you then.
Knife.
Well, how about I just kick him then?
He's got a knife. He doesn't look happy.
Well, what kind of shit can I do to his semi to get him to, pay some attention to me here? I don't want to go just stealing his truck.
I really need a ride.
I realize I put off this exterior of a rough and tumble type character, but that's not actually what I'm trying. I'm trying to be a good person here. I'm trying to make good choices. Oh, right. I thought I still had that lockpick. Oh, okay. Well, then let's show the picture to him then. I didn't realize I had a new item. I thought I still was just carrying the lockpick.
I need to get to this place. Uncle Pete's Mink Ranch.
I need to go in that direction too, but the pigs are running the sty tonight.
How poetic.
In that case, maybe I can hop on the bike and chase the police off in some way? Go round back the bar? Oh, to like where the dumpster was and stuff. Forgot about this area. Is there someone hiding in the dumpster?
Over here!
Good call there.
No time to talk.
You know, it stank in there, but I can't remember a better sleep.
You gotta help me. Go find my editor in Corville. Tell him I took pictures of the Corley murder.
You got pictures?
Yeah, but some thug took my camera.
So you don't have any pictures?
Well, I tracked the guy to Melonweed, but I'm not going near the place. They'd kill me. Get my editor. He's gotta get me out of this. Take one of these fake IDs to get through the roadblocks.
Nice. You got enough fake IDs there?
My career is riding on those pictures. Help me, Ben. You're my only hope.
Oh, don't worry. I owe you one.
Was that like a very, very roundabout Star Wars reference?
That could be Miranda's camera I saw there. But then, who's got the film?
Help me, Ben. You're my only hope. Oh, and the achievement was A New Hope, so it definitely is. Help me, Ben. You're my only hope. Help me, Obi-Wan Kenobi. You're my only hope. Obi-Wan Kenobi was using Ben Kenobi as like a disguise, a moniker. That was a very roundabout, convoluted Star Wars reference, but it still landed. So good work on writing that one, guys. Maybe this guy will help me out if I got a fake ID, or am I just supposed to go it alone? No, because they'll be looking for me.
What's that?
Fake federal investigator ID. Could be of some use at one of those roadblocks.
Don't stab it, you fool. That was useful.
I can find my bike.
It's buried in a pile of concentrated fertilizer powder.
That voice actor was terrible. The one who plays the
now you're gonna ride
girl who took the pictures?
The engine compartment?
Hey, I smuggle stuff in there all the time, and most of it's worth more than you. So stuff your carcass in there quick, and we might hit that mink dump by morning.
Hope you're better with a stick shift than you are with a knife.
Yeah.
I hope I stuck my motorcycle in there somewhere and that I'm not just ditching it.
Oh, great. Smells like he's got a fuel leak. I love engine fires.
That doesn't sound too pleasant. I assume you're being sarcastic, right, but when you say everything in the same gruff monotone, it's hard to tell sometimes.
Jump, check it out.
Huh? What's this about?
Undercover agricultural sting operation.
What's in the back?
Fertilizer.
All right, move along.
Hope you rubes get your man.
You rubes. Good thing you didn't check. Fertilizer, such a believable response, because it probably smells like shit. Yeah, it just sounded out of place. Very 1920s New York. I think that's what they were going for, this old, like, extra style reporter person. But yeah, it doesn't totally fit, but I guess that's supposed to be the character. It's kind of... I'm not a big fan of that character in general so
problem
far.
Your truck?
Loose hose and nothing big. I already pulled your bike out. It's sitting right over there. Well, nice knowing you. Gotta hit the road, you know.
Oh, well, I guess see you later then, Emmett. Thanks for the help. Hey, we're right here, right at the ranch. But it does seem to be quite boarded up.
He did have a fuel leak, and he took my fuel line to fix it. That trucker's gonna die for what he did.
You're gonna kill him for that? Jesus, I think you got some anger issues, Ben. I mean, I get you're pissed about that and you're part of a biker gang, but you gotta start seeking, like, alternative solutions here. Something more peaceful, perhaps. Killing him doesn't seem like the way to go. We'll just go right in the front entrance then, shall we? Take a quick look in here, probably gonna be locked.
Tough looking padlock. There's a picture of Maureen and Malcolm. Looks like they're restoring an old hardtail together. This must be the window Maureen stared out of as a young girl, dreaming of her life repairing toasters.
What are these gross ponytails hanging from the roof? Oh, pelts.
Looks like a mink pelt.
That makes a little bit more sense. Can we go look at the pillow? You gonna take a nap there, Ben? There's things that need doing. We'll just grab the pillow then. Maybe there's something under it. Yes. Trusty tire iron. Always tire irons.
That's the insignia of the vultures. I can't believe Mo used to be a vulture. But then again, how else could she have gotten that recoil booster?
It makes sense if you ask me. Let's see. Anything else you can do? Can't grab a pelt, probably. Hard to reach.
I'm not into furs.
Okay, man. I didn't say you were. I wasn't trying to make any assumptions about your character or anything. Can I just beat this guy open? That's one tough padlock. Oh, there we go.
And a hose I can use on my bike. I don't think Mo would mind if I borrow him.
I actually really didn't think that would work. Oh, I thought they were stealing my bike. Oh, I was gonna be pissed. Oh. Thank you. Thank you, Barda. That's awesome. Thank you so much, dude. That's, if anything, it kind of works as a little bit of, like, a recoup on this particular game, because it was, like, $13 or something like that, so thank you. But I'll keep an eye out for some new stuff. There's actually, like, a whole list of games that just came out today, so I've been kind of, like, eyeballing a few of them. There's actually, I've been on this whole kick of remastered games, I guess, because, we had, what the hell is it? I've been playing Planescape Torment, which is the enhanced edition. I got this Full Throttle remastered. And later tonight, I think Brett from the channel, her and I are going to play Voodoo Vince Remastered, which I already bought, which also just came out today. So I guess it's going towards the remastered games fund, I suppose. So thank you for that. That's super awesome, man. That's fucking sweet. The donation that you were seeing before that was like scrolling across on the screen was... not real. I just had to enter a fake one so I could actually have something scrolling along the bottom there just to test out and make sure it was like working properly. That's awesome, thank you. So you're officially our sole donator. So that's and a Patreon? Man, thank you for all the support you've given. That's so awesome, dude. I gotta try and switch back over to game mode, but I am super stoked about that. That, like, means a lot to me, so thank you, dude. But it looks like I'm gonna have to fight, like, a whole crew of guys here. Holy shit! This is a violent game. People are getting killed all over the place here. He just shot a packet of dynamite at his truck. I mean, they're not playing very nice here. I expected this game to be a little bit more G-rated. You're gonna blow up the whole bridge. Oh, Emmett, you're fucked. I mean, damn him. He stole that fire or that fuel hose. He deserved it. That's exactly how that should have went.
We have been tricked, my brothers. Back to the cave.
That guy sounds like Cobra Commander or something. That was strange, that voice acting. What are those characters? What the hell are those desert bandits?
Wrong and she ain't coming here.
She's coming.
Oh, that guy's not dead. I thought that guy might have been dead.
All we have to do is sit here and wait.
You know, I actually do already have Tides of Numenera. I was a Kickstarter backer for it because I thought it sounded like a cool project. I had backed Wasteland 2, which was also in Exile Entertainment, I think. I think they were both the same company, so I was just like, oh, Wasteland was cool. I'll back Tides of Numenera. So I do actually already have it, but then when I heard there was going to be like the Planescape Enhanced Edition, I was like, oh, I guess I won't play it. I'll just wait and play the Enhanced Edition. A lot of people have been saying that they think the Numenera doesn't quite live up to the high standards set by Planescape Torment. And so we'll see. Planescape Torment's going to be around on the channel for a long time, I'm envisioning. So we'll see if and when there'll be room for Tides of Numenera. If Planescape, you know, stays popular or anything like that, then I would be interested in playing the sequel. But for now, it's not really in the books, but somewhere down the line might be a thing. Anytime, man, love your stuff, so I know it's in good hands. Thanks, dude. That's awesome. That's so cool. I just need a minute to enjoy that. Thank you. That's a really cool moment. Thank you, dude. Hopefully I can keep up some high quality content for a long time and make it worth the dollars. Let's see here. What do we got here? This is all Emmett's truck, right? Where are you climbing to? Where'd you just run off to, Ben? You were just supposed to like interact with this here. Where the hell did you go? Come back here, Ben. I feel like he got stuck or something. There we are. What the hell, man? Was it really necessary to take the absolute longest way possible? Where are you going?
There we go.
Ew, gross. Don't say that. Don't say things like that, man. That means too many other things. Euro, sorry I couldn't change that. Not a problem. I'm pretty sure the way it works is just kind of like caches and then it like auto converts or whatever. So no, don't concern yourself with that. Not an issue. I'm having fun too. I hit the bell icon so I can keep watching the series at the very least. Oh, cool. Thanks, man. Yeah, it's I'm hoping to try and knock out a part two of this stream, possibly tomorrow. I do work super early in the morning, so if I'm too tired, I might have to put it off a couple days. But I'll definitely be doing like streaming the other half of this somewhere down the line. No, don't walk all the way around there. It's not what I'm looking for. Oh, it's fertilizer. I was just trying to figure out what the heck it even was.
Stinking mess.
Agreed, I've never actually been notified by a channel before. Do you have that set up on here now? I've actually never even set it up. I have channels that I really like to follow, and I've still never even used the notification system properly. Because for me, people talk about how like videos don't show up in their subscription bar window thing, and for me, I've never had that as an issue. It always has let me know when new videos have come out just in the new video panel, so I've never felt the need to click the notification icon, but I might have to test it out for some people.
I'm not putting my lips on that.
You don't want to eat any stinking fertilizer? Why the heck not? I doubt he can use a tire iron on here. Well, I'm just going to get you to grab the wheel?
It's bolted on.
What? I didn't realize that the wheels were... I didn't realize I could click on them independently. Well, let's try and steal a wheel from here then, maybe. Why exactly do I want to steal a wheel?
All of them.
Oh, I'm just getting the nuts.
That up now.
Wait, what?
The truck has them pinned.
Oh, I see. Well, that's not gonna do me much good then, is it?
The truck has them pinned.
What if I just kick it? Use one of your manly swift kicks, Ben, and kick it right off there. Whoa! That... I did not expect that to work. What the hell, man? Now how are you gonna get those tires? Maybe I wouldn't have been able to push it without loosening up the tires. Maybe that was supposed to be maybe that was the proper order of things. Yeah, I hit the bell and I get push notifications on my phone. Oh, okay, so that's pretty helpful then. It's mostly for your streams, my other subscriptions. I can usually predict what time they're posting daily videos. Okay, yeah, that makes sense. Can you climb right in there now, maybe? No.
I'd call that a road hazard.
Is that what you were... That's probably what I was trying to do, though, was create a big road hazard. Not a lot of people I follow do streams.
I've done my heavy lifting for the day.
Or if they do, maybe they do them over on Twitch or something, and I've never really gotten into Twitch. Nothing against it. I just personally prefer keeping things all in one place, so I have mostly just stuck with doing things on YouTube. Well, I think that's all I was trying to do there, is like create a shitty road hazard, right? So that's about as messy and sloppy as it's gonna get. So let's roll on past this, I suppose. Ooh, I'm gonna have to fight some people down this way here. I can actually control this. This is me controlling it with the mouse. Take the exit. Some of this navigating is getting a little bit more complicated now. I actually have to like choose where I'm going and stuff rather than just the game kind of auto taking me places. I only get notified by like 3 channels, even though I should get notified by more. It sucks. Oh, do you have it set up to notify more than that, and then it still only notifies you 3? It is super annoying.
Father Torque.
Father Torque? Cool name.
I haven't seen you since you retired from the Polecats.
Hey, Ben. How's my gang doing?
That's a long story.
What are you doing out here? Father Torque, I need your help. You know a way around Puyahoga Gorge. That was a difficult one.
What are you doing out here?
Well, retirement's pretty boring, Ben. So I thought I'd come out to the old mine road and look for trouble.
You're picking fights?
That's what the old mine road's for, son.
Could have picked up some of the stuff that fell out. Some of that fertilizer goop? Maybe I could have. I kind of just left it alone. I thought that maybe I would need a bucket or something to pick it up with, so I didn't really try, but maybe I need to go back and give that a try.
Any fighting tips, Torque?
Ah, Ben, who's tougher than you?
Nobody, but those rod wheelers are uglier.
They're none too bright either. I'm sure you can handle them.
Cavefish.
What's up with those cavefish, man?
Watch out, Ben. They're not out here for sport. They hijack big rigs. It's part of their religion. Don't get in their way. They're blind, cold-hearted killers.
Guess those are the guys that were blowing stuff up. That's exactly what I was thinking, but obviously that's not what he meant.
They're only blind because they wear those special goggles to shield their sensitive cave-dwelling eyes. Special sensors in the goggles pick up the dots in the road and other large objects and landmarks to help them navigate. Kind of trippy, huh?
I didn't realize he meant they were actually blind. I thought he was saying they were like blind, rage-filled guys, like they're such angry people that they can't see past their own rage or whatever. I was totally misinterpreting that. I think you could have picked up... I already read that one. Quick.
The vultures are quick, and they're nuts.
The ones with those boosters are hard to whip. Just remember, Ben, it's not about muscle, it's about timing.
Nobody's tougher than Ben. He kicks everything. I try, even when it is detrimental. The time I should have knocked on that door, and instead I immediately kicked it, and then kicked it literally every time after that. I do kick everything, but apparently it's not always the best answer. I wish it didn't take so long for messages to pop up. I keep trying to send something before you leave areas. Oh yeah, it's like a full, like, 15 second delay somewhere up around in that. It's brutal, really. I have streamed over on Beam before, and it's incredible because it's like zero latency, instantaneous, basically. It's like 0.5 seconds of a delay, something incredible like that. It's so good. But then the archived versions of those streams look like shit. And it's hard to advertise to the people who follow on YouTube to go over to Beam. Beam's not that popular yet. Otherwise, I would prefer to do it over there, I think.
You know any way around Cuyahoga Gorge?
Around it? It's miles and miles long, Ben. What's the matter? Don't like bridges?
It blew up.
Ooh, sorry I missed that. Well, you could jump it, like Ricky Myron. Cavefish got his ramp in their hideout, you know.
I wonder if that's the legitimate solution I'm looking for here.
Where is the Cavefish hideout exactly?
Somewhere on this road. The entrance is totally invisible, unless you've got those weird Cavefish specs.
Father Tork, I need your help. The gang's in jail and the law...
Ben, I'm not the leader of the Polecats anymore. You are. Can't you see I'm on permanent vacation? Can't talk anymore, Ben. Eating too many bugs.
Well, take it easy, Father.
Give him hell, Polecat.
I thought you were like a Polecat for life, or at the very least, like, you know, whatever gang you're a part of for life. What is this weird character? Oh, it's one of these guys. Yeah, this is what I want. I want to ram one of these guys off the road. Oh, shit. Well, that didn't work very well. I wanted to ram one of those guys and steal their goggles. Yeah, it's quite the delay, but oh well. Yeah, it's annoying as hell. What? What did I do there? I guess I just rammed too far off the side. I was accidentally letting it drift. I wonder if I can go back to where that fertilizer was and maybe grab some of that. Now I'm not going to remember exactly which way I need to go in order to reclaim that stuff. Let's not ram him too soon. Wait for things to line up a bit better. And give him a few quick punches. Oh, he's using an actual weapon, but I'm just going to punch him in the head repeatedly. And presumably that'll just work forever, like it did that one time. Come on, I've almost pushed you off the road. There's no reason for this to not be working. Yeah, suck it. Suck it, you dick. Oh, shit. Do I get his weapon now? Do I get to fight with that badass fucking thing? Because that should make this a hell of a lot easier then. My future encounters should go a little bit more my way, I'm assuming. It's a very badass looking picture. Might have to crop that one out and use it for the thumbnail of the next stream, I'm thinking. Oh, yeah. Yeah, we're gonna whip this guy big time. Come for a lesson in kind. Is this guy Australian? It seemed like he had a little bit of an accent going on there. No, you can't beat me. You're using a board. I'm using a big chain ball. But I can beat a guy with a chain ball when I use my fist. There's a double standard there. Oh, fuck. Maybe just ramming yourself straight into him, whipping randomly, isn't the exact strategy you're meant to use. That's a cool weapon, though. Damn straight. Oh, look at this crazy hair. Oh, it's a lady! Lady biker. Oh, I also got my tire iron.
Wow, are you really a Polecat?
Yes, I am.
And I'm gonna ram you off the road. There we go, it wasn't working for a minute there. It only took a few quick bashes to knock her off. I mean, there was a direct connection straight in the middle of her face, like forehead, bridge of the nose. You're not going to live through too many of those, I don't think. Pretty aggressive there, Ben. No one's going to mess with you. Am I just running loops right now? Like, maybe I do need to take one of these exits when they come along. Nope. No time for that. Still too busy fighting. Give me a... Trying to get a few quick head bashes in.
Time for the final exam.
Come on, there we go. It's hard to line these up. I don't know, sometimes it doesn't work properly. I don't know exactly what it takes to line these up. I'm just kind of spamming the shit out of the attack button. Fuck. Well, those aren't working too well. Let me take one of these exits here and try and investigate somewhere else. Maybe back to that fertilizer area. Maybe I can collect some of that. No, this seems to be back out on the main road. No, I wanted to stop through that. I didn't mean to just drive straight through it. Whoops. Do you live in the States, Graeme? No, I'm in Canada, in fact. So I am a little unfamiliar with the States. I know the West Coast a bit better than the East, but maybe you were just wondering roughly whereabouts I'm from. Let me just yoink a random exit here. I don't even know what I'm doing anymore. I'm just kind of weaving all over the place. I feel like I gotta find one of these cave fish and take them down so I can try and get to their secret hideout here. I don't want to...
Is that a pre-regulation destroyer class solid fuel recoil booster you have there?
Why, yes it is.
That sounds like Mark Hamill. That's totally Mark Hamill. I don't know if that's his only appearance in this game, like if that character is going to be recurring, or if he was doing an extra voice in the game, aside from whatever main character he's voicing. Oh, this was the wrong way to go. Ben is really tough, though. He can just brush those bike crashes off like nothing. Yeah, his bike seems to really withstand a lot of damage, too, after that first big spill it took. Snow Mexicans. Yeah. Oh, I guess this is talking about the guy who did his daredevil jump. Schmetterlings.
One of the gorge's many casualties. Ricky Myron's infamous gorge jump. This is the last picture ever taken of Professor Schmetterling.
Professor Schmetterling is just a great name.
Jumping the Cuyahoga Gorge, although tempting, is highly illegal and dangerous. We recommend the recently constructed Cuyahoga Gorge Bridge for transgorge travel.
What were people doing before that was constructed? I thought so. I'm in BC and thought you sounded like you were from around here. I'm on Vancouver Island. Oh, I'm over in Alberta. Kind of mid central Alberta myself. Yeah, that's funny. I people tend to pick up on it. A lot of the time when I'm using words like out, Schmetterling meaning butterfly. Oh, I knew that too. One of my bosses at an old job I worked at, there was a German guy that we worked with. And the German guy asked, like, does anyone speak German? Does anyone know any German? He was just kind of curious if anyone did. And my boss was like, oh, yes, I do, in fact. Schmetterling! And he would just scream it. And everyone was like, what the fuck? And he was like, it means butterfly. it was just his example of how the Germans have a knack for turning very harmless-sounding words into very aggressive-sounding things. That's funny. I wonder why the hell they made him Dr. Butterfly or Professor Butterfly then. What's this about living in mountain time? That's cool. Yeah, that is that is in fact the time zone I live in. It's all right. It's a cool name for a time zone. I'll give you that. Let's see if I can collect some of this stuff. Just like a handful.
Just take a little.
his little quick bend over to grab it was pretty hilarious. Wow, alright, I got myself a tire iron, I got my skull whip, and I got a nice handful of fertilizer. It took me a while to re-find it and to properly stop at it, but now I got some. I should have thought to try and take some before. Alright, now I guess I can only go the one way. Navigating through these canyons is kind of nimbly bimbly. I'm really uncertain where I need to be going, so I should try and keep track. I'm on the Mine Road 4 right now, and I think I just came off of the 9, and so this would be taking me back out onto the 9, so I better stick it out around here for a little while I try and beat up a few more goons, perhaps. Oh, I can throw fertilizer at them. I probably gotta save that for the guy who's got the super fast bike, though. Why was that one so easy? I have no idea. I feel like I gotta try and cause the guy with the fast bike to wipe out, or use it on the cave fish or something like that. I might have to, it might be like a rock, paper, scissors sort of thing with the weapons, I'm not sure. Me, only a little bit of, only know a little bit of German. I know it's Ich bin Berliner, which means I'm from Berlin. And I am a bun called a Berliner. Sorry, it's hard to try and read that. Oh, I didn't mean to throw that at him right now.
Gotta run.
Oh, I collected like a chain of pearls or some shit. I am a bun called a Berliner. Oh, come on. Let's see. I'm really racking up the weapons here. Is this just supposed to be a chain?
Eat this, Charlie.
Doesn't seem like a very good weapon to me. Damn it. Every time. Alright, well, what am I going to use to take that guy? I've already taken that guy out once, so I honestly don't really care about fighting that guy anymore. I'm not sure how much time I'm supposed to be committing to fighting these different guys here. And I haven't quite learned exactly how to win these consistently. German sounds really violent, honestly. I like it. I had a buddy who lived in Germany for about 4 months, and he said he made a strong effort while he was there to try and learn it. And he said it was pretty difficult to learn. He did manage to learn quite a bit, but he said it was really difficult to like maintain once he came back. He had nowhere to practice it, and he said he found that he lost it really quickly. Just a small correction: Berliner, not Berliner. Oh, I see what you're saying. Yeah, Berliner. Pretty sure you have to head back to the mink farm. Then perhaps I'll check that out. I've been sitting here trying to beat up the, what are they called? The cave fish, or whatever. I've been specifically looking for them and focusing on trying to do that. I've only heard it. Yeah, I'm liking this cool music we got going on here. I've already gone to the mine road. I've done that a few times. What exit am I looking for here? That's just the mine road again. So that doesn't seem right. And what's this one? More mine road? So all of these exits are just mine road exits? Oh, right. And then you end up back here again. This isn't what I'm looking for, though. So I think I just gotta take off again. There might be an exit off this road, though. Something other than the 9 exit. Then I gotta fight my way through more goons, though? Jesus. Alright, I really don't know how I'm supposed to get back to the ranch. I haven't found the guys I want to be fighting for a little while. Get him! Bash him good! Bash him good, Ben! I feel like I gotta keep my distance a little bit and not rub the bikes together too much. I think that's what causes the wipeouts, maybe? I'm not positive. Nope, still just wipes out anyways. Not having a lot of luck with that. That just takes me back to the 9. What is this crazy loop that I've gotten myself on? I'm not a particularly big fan of this section of the game. Maybe I gotta take this guy out with the fertilizer. He's the speed guy who I think is voiced by Mark Hamill.
Drop anchor or something? Sorry, gotta run.
That doesn't do anything. Fertilizer does nothing. I'm fairly confident that's Mark Hamill, though. Come on. Maybe if I let me try and fertilize other people.
Hey, it's my old friend. What's your name?
Fuck you. I don't care about your shit. I'm beating you up. I'm knocking you out of this race we got going on here. Back on the highway? Damn, I was gonna suggest to not keep banging into it. I think that's part of it? Maybe? It's kind of hit and miss here. Some of it's working, some of it's not. Oh, I was just stopping for that. Yeah, we've already been over this enough times. We'll move on beyond that. Just gotta keep an eye out for an exit. It seems like every exit's the same. Well, German doesn't seem too hard to learn, but that's because Swedish, my first language, is kind of similar to German. Oh, yeah, that's the thing. I think they're very... It's very different from English, even when you just get down to, like, word, like, phrasing orders and everything like that is just, different and hard to learn compared to English, like, if you're used to the English structure. I do know a lot of people who speak French being from Canada, and people who say they speak French, like, I was really surprised. I was trying to show off some of the Spanish I had learned, and I was talking to somebody who spoke French, and they were like, oh yeah, I know all that, because it's basically, it translates almost identically, and so I was thought I was being impressive, and really I wasn't. So like French and Spanish, languages like that are very similar. I don't really know what you could call similar to English, but then there are like languages that are similar, more similar to German. But yeah, your English and French skills aren't going to translate to German very well. Mark Hamill voices Ripburger. Oh, he voices the bad guy? Man, he is doing a good job of showing off his range in this game. Because my one critique of Mark Hamill's voice acting is he tends to play the same character a lot. He does, like, the Joker is standout different, but then when he does, like, the Hobgoblin, or he played that character in Darksiders, he starts to just play all those very similarly. Well, for English people, it's kind of hard, especially since it only has the, where they have der, die, or das. Yeah, like, that has always been trouble for me in French, is like the le and the la and everything. But I started getting a little bit used to it while I was trying to learn Spanish, and it's not as hard as I used to think it was.
You drop anchor or something?
Come on, come on. All right, throwing the fertilizer at that guy is not the right answer here. It's weird, I've heard a lot of Mark voice work, but I can never place it. I think of when I do, it's from his time in Star Wars. All I think of when I do is from his time in Star Wars. Speaking of, the Last Jedi trailer that had just come out. Oh, this seems like a tad frozen, perhaps. Oh, no. Something's gone fucky here all of a sudden. Let me just give it a hot minute to see if it corrects itself. Otherwise, I might need to quickly close the game and boot her back up again. That's seeming like it's not gonna fix itself, so I think the game just froze there. I gotta close the game for a second, sorry. Yeah, what was I thinking? That Last Jedi trailer had just come out, and you can really hear him using his voice acting skills, because Mark Hamill sounds very different nowadays than he did back in Star Wars, obviously. He's like quite a bit older. And you can hear him kind of splitting the difference between his proper sounding new voice and how he sounded back in Star Wars. So I always thought that was kind of cool. Oh, thank God there's auto saves. Because I was like, oh, sweet fuck. How far back am I going to need to go? Oh, good. It seems like I still have all my items and everything too, so I should be fine. My time in the Netherlands, being around a lot of German and Dutch, I can usually understand the context of what's being said, picking up a few words of the conversation. That's what I found with Spanish. I really didn't know, like, any Spanish, but it was context. It was really easy to start picking things up on context. People are just good at communicating. People in general, I mean. You just learn little tricks and ways to, like, mime it out to help people along. It's cool. At this point, English has almost become like my first language because all my friends speak English. That's pretty interesting. That's, you guys, even if their first language is also technically Spanish, you guys would choose to all speak English together?
One of these booster deals.
Good to practice, I suppose. I cannot figure out how to get out of this loop of running around to random areas. Speak English more than Swedish. Yeah, so I guess you would just start getting in the habit of it. I don't know how to get out of this loop, guys, and I also don't seem to be accomplishing anything by continuing on in this loop. So I'm having a lot of difficulty with this section of the game here. The mine road. I've done that a lot. Then there's this one, and then there's kind of like the weird double exit. I'm going to try that one to see if that in any way is different. I feel like he pulls off from the same spot no matter what. So I don't know. I fought that one cave fish, and he got away. And I really thought that what I was trying to do was find another one of them to fight. There, yes!
Lead divers?
That should have a couple of good boosts left in it.
I got really excited about that. I've been sitting here thinking that maybe there was some kind of like rock, paper, scissors thing going on there, and I finally figured out you needed the chain to rip that guy down. But what did I do? Did I steal his bike? Do I have his bike now? I'd like to ask if they dream in their native language or English. Oh, that is interesting. I've wondered that myself too. And what do you find to be more common? That people, I guess maybe it depends what you spent most of your day doing. If you spent most of your day talking in English that particular day, then you might be more likely to be dreaming in English that night. Come on, I thought the tire iron is how you got that guy. There we go. That fascinates me. Honestly, can't remember how to get out of this. Yeah, it's a little bit tricky, it seems. But I made some kind of progress. I knocked down that one guy. I think in English, but my dreams vary a lot. Oh, that's an interesting one. It would make sense to think in whatever language you are speaking more frequently, like at the time. If you're hanging out with a lot of English friends, it makes sense, and like you're consistently speaking English, it makes sense to think in it. Dreaming's so unpredictable. I never know what to think of dreams. Damn you! Alright, I gotta flip through my full weapon rotation there to see if like boost exists as an option now that I took down one of those booster guys. Maybe that is what I was working towards here. This looks like a new guy. I don't think I've fought whatever this red mohawked character is before. Oh, so I can just stomp it. Oh, or it's kicking. How about I kick you off your bike? I want your chainsaw. Give me the chainsaw. Damn it! I wanted that. Depends on the person. One of my friends dreams in the language she speaks to that person. So check for family English for me. Dreams the language he speaks to that person. Yeah, that makes sense. Oh, finally, I got one of these guys. What do I do? I try. Oh, what the fuck? Why? Why did that happen? What did I do? Did I run into the wall again? Son of a bitch. What is even going on here? This section of the game seems poorly conceived. Leg versus chainsaw. Hey, man. It made a lot of sense in my mind. It seemed like the perfect combination. Come on, this big skull whip versus a piece of wood. I think I got you beat. There we go. I just thought my leg might have a little bit more reach. Oh, good. Good, I got a plywood now. But that must work against someone. Oh, am I not encountering characters twice? I'm actually slowly, steadily taking each one out, I think. Come on, throw some fertilizer at him. Oh, he's throwing fuel at me. He's like letting off fuel, so he's tripping me up. With like oil slicks. I thought maybe that's what I was gonna be doing to him. I was wondering why he couldn't kick on his bike. Of course he can. Kicking is useful in every scenario. Of course it had to be tied in somehow. All right, lady, you're getting boarded. If I bash you with the board enough times, does that win? I guess wood versus chainsaw. I should have thought about that one. That one was just bound to fail. Oh, some of these guys are coming back. I thought maybe I was like permanently taking them out, unless I've somehow never beat this guy and just thought that I had. Oh, he's just using his hand. Yeah, get out of here. I've definitely beat that guy before, at least once, if not a couple times. So what? I haven't tried much on this guy. I haven't really had the opportunity to. So let's keep our distance a little bit. Let's see, what's he gonna do?
Can't reach.
Nope. Maybe I could kick him. Kick him. I could dodge. I was able to dodge his oil slick, but then I don't know what to do after that. Was there anything back on the bridge? You need to poison her drink. Very few people in this stream are gonna pick up on that, but I spent a significant amount of time in my latest Planescape episode trying to poison a drunk lady because some guy asked me to make sure she paid her tab, and I got it in my head that poisoning her was the right thing to do, and so I committed really hard to that. Get out of here! Don't use your hands. We're men. We use weapons and chains and stuff. We don't want to get our dainty hands all mixed up. There might have been something back at the bridge. I thought I'd given it a good look over. I feel like there's something I gotta be able to do to this guy, but I have yet to figure it out. Keep my distance for a moment. Maybe I can stick a plank in his tires or something like that. Oh, fucking whacked him right in the back. I don't know. I'll go back to the bridge because Hey, I got a cat in the room. I don't own a cat. No, I do. But I guess I'll go back to the bridge and try some of that. Try and look around there a little bit more because these continuous little fights don't seem to be doing much for me. But I've taken out most people. I must be progressing towards something, the fact that I keep taking out more and more of them. Right? I thought that I took out that one guy with the booster, that I would get some sort of cool booster upgrade, but I don't think that's how that worked. Just sail on through the fertilizer, and this should take me through to the bridge. Right? This is how I got to the bridge, right? Maybe I had to take a different exit, but I'm pretty sure there really is just only the two roads. Shit. Am I going back the other way? Did I actually turned myself around and going the other way now? I finally went, what the fuck? I thought I had tried this. I thought for sure I had tried this.
Look at him run.
God damn it. Whatever. At least we eventually got out of it. I have no idea how I eventually exited the right way and it eventually worked. I don't have a fucking clue. But I feel like I gotta lead him into the oil slick, right? I think you can use the fertilizer on the chainsaw girl. Maybe, I will have to try that. But for now, I think I'm just trying to get this guy to get blocked up in this fertilizer trap, right? Yeah! Take that, guys. Whose limousine is this now? Oh, it must be Rip Burger's.
Boss, it was Nestor's fault.
Get in quick. I have a plan.
We're going. Oh, I can hear Mark Hamill in there.
Out of hiding with a bike.
Boss, she already has a bike.
Yes, but this one she worked on with her father. It's an emotional thing. Don't try to understand. Now hurry.
Now I can't get it out of my head. Now that I know that that's Mark Hamill, it's like so obvious to me. Ah, I can't believe I didn't notice before. So this is just... Is that arrow just saying continue
something
on down
the
road?
The bridge is out.
Something tells you, huh? I thought he was going to go around the area there. What else could I maybe do around here? You can look at the bridge, you can look at the gorge, you can look at the signs. I've done all that. So maybe now I need to go back to the ranch? Maybe? Now that that stuff's been dealt with? And if not, then I can go back onto the road and try my hand at fighting some more of those characters again. Sorry, I just had to check a text again. Nothing particularly important. Actually, it was a friend of mine asking if I'm free to play D&D this Sunday, which unfortunately I don't think that I am. Oh, I could have stopped. If I stop here, can I turn around and go the other way to investigate that car there? Because that's what I want to do. Yeah, whip yourself around, let's go stop at that car, that new wreck that we've created, and see what there is to see there. I I haven't played D&D in so long. It is so tempting. I might just have to see if I do have the free time after all. It's funny that they made hover cars in this game strictly for the whole thing of, like, I don't touch anything that doesn't have wheels.
That's trashed.
Trashed. Just a bunch of trash.
I don't touch anything without wheels.
Yeah, that whole thing. You're just happy with yourself about that one, are ya? Well, let's see. I got all kinds of things. What can I bash this up a little bit, maybe? Oh. Didn't necessarily expect that, but okay. What did I just rip out of there? What did I possibly just take? A fan. Fan of some kind? Alright, who knows what good that could do, but whatever. That worked out. And probably can't.
I should save something that potent for the mine road.
The mine road. Yeah, so there is someone I'm supposed to be using that against on the mine road.
I'm saving that for the...
All of this is just mine road.
Chain from my friends on the old.
Yeah, all of these are just specifically old mine road items, I guess.
Something like that has only one use. The old mine road.
Alright, well, I managed to rip the fan out of this thing. I think that must have been all I could do with the car, I'm guessing. So let's get back on the bike, head to the mine road, and try and use some of these other items. Some of these other pikers. Yeah, that's the plan for right now. I just had to get a little bit of a stretch in there. Two and a half hours of gaming, sitting in one spot, is starting to feel a little long. 3 hours, I think, is the most I've ever streamed for, and it's like right up around my upper limit there. Depending, I'm sure someday there'll be a game that'll get me playing more. I probably would play more of this in one sitting today if I didn't have things I needed to do. I don't know if you saw it, I tweeted to your personal account, but Roll20 is an online D&D. Oh yeah, I did see that. Did I not reply to that? Sorry if I didn't reply to that. Yeah, that is interesting to me, because I knew that online D&D stuff like that was, that it existed. I've never looked into using it myself, but that could be pretty cool. I don't have a fan, so I do want to try and kick this guy, I think. I want him to use his oil, then I'll sneak in there and kick him. Yeah, doing some online D&D stuff would be cool. It's something I do want to look into, but I just haven't... damn it! Damn him, he's really good at timing that. No, I just haven't really looked into setting it up yet. I've been quite busy and probably will be for a while. I got a couple animations that need to be done. I'm working on a game. I got another game beyond that probably needs to be finished as well. I got a bunch of shit on the go. Throwing on a D&D session type thing might end up being a bit much at the moment. But someday I might give it a try. You can put the fan on your bike because that was stolen from your bike. Oh, that would make sense. Then you can jump the ravine. Oh, I don't need that ramp? I thought I was building up to getting that ramp that the guy jumped the gorge with. Ah, shit. As soon as you get close to those guys, they ink ya. You can create character sheets. There's Fog of War controlled by the Dungeon Master and everything. That sounds pretty sweet. I'd feel satisfied by kicking that car, too. The owners are fucking douchebags. I think that's how you spell it. Yes. Yeah, that is the correct spelling. A handy spelling lesson in today's stream. How to spell douchebag. Hit him with the plank when he lifts his head. Oh, yeah, he's always ducking down there. All right, I'll give that a try. And I don't think we've tried the fertilizer on her. You said to maybe give that one a try, so I'll try and slick her up. There, get you good and greased up. Come on, what? It's throwing, the way he throws the grease, he's always throwing it kind of behind him, and the wind catches it, and it doesn't do a whole lot. The fertilizer being thrown at these people doesn't seem to work, even though he specifically had his quote saying, oh, something that potent, seems like it should be saved for the old mine road. Just can't seem to get these things to work out, can I? Give him a few quick chain bashes. This guy's always a pain in the ass. He's a little bit tough compared to some of the other ones. I wish I didn't have to keep refighting him, seeing as I've taken him down a few times now. just want to fight the new guys, the people I haven't beat yet. Alright, hopefully I can take on the cat fish, the cave fish, guy. Test out the plank theory. Ah, what haven't I done with the chainsaw person? Maybe if I use a chain against the chainsaw? I've already used it successfully against another character, so we'll see. Gotta pay extra attention to this character's, like, movement and everything. I've only successfully dodged the ink, like, once. Yes! Yes! Brilliant! Thank you, Bane! Finally! Oh, cool, now I got the goggles! Now I got the goggles on. Oh, I didn't want to immediately have to fight another dude. Whatever then, I guess. I still want that chainsaw too. It's like the last thing on this road that I don't have. You use the chain on the fast dude. It is one per thing, hey? It's like, it's not gonna work on more than one character. If it worked on the fast dude, then it's not gonna work on a different one. Oh, I tire ironed this girl very easily, so I assume that's still the case. I'm starting to re-encounter all these characters now. Equip goggles. I don't want to right now. I want to try and get the chainsaw. I've used pretty much everything. The boot. No, I tried this. I tried using the boot on this character. Fuck. Let's chop you down and catch him. Oh! There you go, right in your eyes. Okay. I guess before I hadn't been throwing it in your eyes properly. Now I think I have every item. So now I might as well flick these goggles on. Oh. Did I equip them? I meant to. I thought that I had. I'm gonna try the chainsaw out. Yeah, the chainsaw's badass. That really did some hefty damage here. Alright, equip the goggles. Ooh, those look pretty cool, don't they? I want to kind of go back out on the road, stop, and put that fan back in my bike, but I guess that's not... I'll focus on this for right now, but maybe the mine road isn't where you find those exits. Maybe I find the cavefish exit back up on the highway? I just assumed it would be down on the mine road, because... seems weird for that to be like just off the highway. Didn't make a lot of sense to me. This part of the game with all the like the 3D and the crashes and everything, it was a little bit difficult and took a little while. Not the worst thing ever. It's just it kind of surprises me a little bit because it was pretty well put together considering the game's 22 years old. Pretty damn good looking like 3D, even though it's like quasi 3D, they did a good job on it. And oh, can I only put the goggles on down on the mine road? Alright, well let's take a stop and so that we can try and put the fan into the bike then. So you hop off your bike, let's bust out some items and try and put that fan back in here.
Looks okay for an aftermarket part.
It worked. He did put it on. Okay.
I don't think that's how they're used.
I was trying to tell you to put it on yourself. Yeah, so I think he's got the fan back in there now. Let's hop on the bike and ride. Now I just gotta think of where I ought to be going. I feel like I need to go with the cavefish thing and get that ramp to jump the gorge. The cavefish exit must be... Maybe I'm supposed to... Well, right, I can't put the goggles on up above there, so it must be something I have to do down below here. So what am I missing? They said that they use the dots in the road to keep track of where they're going. You need to take out the fast guy. I already did take him out. Didn't I? I totally already did. That looks like the regular exit. I've done that exit a million times. Like now I need to take out the fast guy? Because I haven't encountered him, I don't think, since I originally took him out. I've been planning to change my username to Wakabaka Bukadukut. Tuka Puka Nuka. What do you guys think? It seems like a mouthful. And I don't know if that's from something. If that's a reference, it's over my head. I don't know that one. Seems like a lot. Seems like a lengthy one. Possibly, I guess on YouTube you type in an email rather than your username, because that seems like it would be worth not the effort of typing in such a large email. This chainsaw is great. Makes taking these guys out super easy. Maybe, yeah, let's see if I encounter one of these speed guys and try and rip him down with the chain. It seems like putting the fan in didn't really do anything, as far as I can tell. Ah, not the fast guy again, but I'm re-encountering things, so maybe I got the fast guy coming up. I'm just gonna stick with the chainsaw. It works much better. Everyone just bails as soon as someone busts out a chainsaw. I don't think you did, because you should get his booster. Right, I definitely yanked him down, and something kind of almost glitchy happened there. That, like, he was, like, saying something about the booster, and then it just kind of was, I was just back on the road again. It was, like, an incomplete sequence, so I don't entirely know what happened there. Whoops. Dropped my pen. My little fiddling pen. I don't actually need it for anything. I just keep playing around with it anyways. I guess I'll just keep fertilizing your face. I'd be tempted to go chainsaw versus chainsaw against her, but now that I know that this works, just throw that right in her eyes. I think I took out the fast guy, but I don't have a booster in my inventory, and it seems unlikely that it would just auto-equip or anything like that, so I don't know what's happening there. I'm loving how easy this is. I wish I would have collected that chainsaw a lot sooner, I think. I gotta try the goggles again. It's from a song called Coconut Sharks in the Water. It's not even an official 21 Pilots song, but I love it. It's not an official 21 Pilots song, so it's like a B-side or something, or someone like remixed or altered a 21 Pilots song. I've never heard of that. They have some pretty cool stuff, though. Might have to check it out. Whack-a-back-a booka dooka booka nuka. That's... Oh, shit, I accidentally clicked it. I didn't mean to take those off right now. Now I'm committed to fighting fat, bald guy again. No, I wasn't looking forward to fighting you right now. This wasn't supposed to be the plan. I'll just take this guy out quickly. Get those goggles back on. Like, what the shit? I keep getting committed to these battles. Okay, chainsaw versus chainsaw doesn't work, so I'll get the fertilizer back out. Ah, fuck you. Fuck you, then. That's what I think about that. I am confident I took out the booster guy, but I don't... Nothing really seems to indicate that that happened. I don't know if my bike looks different or anything like that. I can't believe how long I've been looping around this mine road, this, like, general section of the game. It seems like it's been... ages. Again, just an excruciating long time. And I'm not really finding anything. Just a bunch of purple walls. That's just the highway exit. No cool special exit is revealing itself to me. Father Torque, I don't know if you know what you were talking about. Fuck. I didn't mean to take that off again, but honestly, I wasn't finding anything, so I don't know what to do. I think I'm gonna go back out on the highway, take a peek around, maybe try and go back to the ranch. I haven't gone back to the ranch in a while. If I get turned around, maybe something useful will be there. I don't know if I'm heading the right direction or not. It was kind of a one-time concert song. From before, it was just Tyler and Josh in the band. It's my favorite band. That's neat. That's funny that they have, like, little songs that they used to play live that never made it on an album or anything. I'm sure lots of bands have stuff like that, but no, had never heard of that one. I think I'm going the right way towards the ranch, because I went past the car, past the wreck, should be the ranch coming up next. There should be a cave entrance pop up. Did you see one? I didn't see one. I don't know what's going on. I might be missing something. There might be like a step in this whole process that I'm still missing. When you're wearing the goggles, I gotta put those goggles back on, and then I gotta like take my hand off the mouse, because that was a few times that I accidentally clicked the thing, and it's super annoying. If I look through my items here, I don't think I have. I'm not like carrying a booster, so I guess that's not the case.
Open up, you minx.
No, that's about everything I was supposed to get from the farm, I think. I guess let's head back to the old mine road for the 100th time. Lots of looping around in this game trying to solve some of these puzzles. And then once we've done that, I'll put on the goggles, take my hands off, let it play out, see how that goes. That archway of ripped up scrap stuff is kind of cool. No one's commenting on that in the game here. Throw those goggles on. Hands off. Just let it do its thing. I've seen it come up a couple times, once or twice or however many, of like the highway entrance exit. Yeah, so there's just that one right there. Take the exit. No thank you. Still looking for the cave. It's the highway as well. It's difficult when it still includes the ability to take the highway exits when I'm trying to look for an exit. Makes it a little bit more difficult. So here's like that overpass section. Am I supposed to be doing something? Am I supposed to be like scanning or something? Nothing. No dice. I'm totally stuck on this one. I'm firing up a walkthrough quickly here. You can have the chainsaw. When you come across a vulture, you'll have to be quick because this guy has a tendency to speed away. Chain is the fastest weapon. Knock him over and you'll be set. You'll have to fight a cave fish. The guy's tough. Doesn't fight back. You get the goggles. If you can't handle all this and you want to be a big pansy, just hit left, shift, and V to bypass the fight. Really? You can skip? I'm not skipping. I collected everything. You only need to get across the gorge is the ramp, which is hidden in the cavefish hideout. Travel the road until a picture of the goggles appears in the upper right-hand corner of the screen, then hit the right mouse button to keep them on. Keep an eye out for the word cave to appear in the lower left corner of the goggles view area. Then click. I feel like that's what I've been doing. I feel like I've been doing this. What am I missing out on here? Graeme, have you been to a concert before? If so, which band? Was it a fun concert? Ooh. I went on like a really big concert kick. I try to go to... There was a while there where I was going to like one a month. I try to go to probably... I'm not sure. I guess I can't say exactly how often I go to concerts. I haven't been going to lots lately. But I try to go to as many as I can. The first one I ever went to was 3 Days Grace when I was like 14 or something like that. It was a fun concert. It was outside and everything, which was super cool. So there was that, but 3 Days Grace, not the greatest band. Honestly, if I had to guess, what I've been going to concerts for like 10 years, I probably average going to like 5 concerts a year. I've probably gone to like 50 concerts. Alexis on Fire, it's one of the best bands I've seen. They put on an absolutely incredible show. Dropkick Murphys was fucking super good. That one was a ton of fun. I've gone to Sasquatch Festival like 3 times. And there's just Foo Fighters. Oh, I've seen Foo Fighters twice. Foo Fighters is incredible. They They've got to be a top contender for, like, most entertaining band you can see live. I love going to concerts. And plus, I've gone to, like, a ton of, like, local shows and stuff, just local artists that I like. I try to support that when I can. And they're usually cheap. They're, like, 10 or 15 bucks or something. I went and saw Elbows. Still not the Cave. I went and saw Elbow in Melbourne a few years back. It was one of the greatest nights of my life. Had just broken up with my ex. Was very freeing going out myself. You know, sometimes people, like, are really unwilling to go out and do stuff like that by themselves. It can be fantastic, if you're in a relationship or not. It's just like, hey, get out for a minute and just, like, my brother was telling me he went to a movie by himself, like, not long ago. And he was like, huh, I've never really done that before. It was actually kind of great. And I personally had never tried it either. Sounded like a fun time. Elbow. I don't know Elbow, though, unfortunately, so maybe it's something I'll have to check out. I listen to pretty much everything except country. Yeah, like, pretty much everything except country. The only... Oh, what was I thinking? Where was I going with that? Oh, I just tend to have a tendency to listen to a lot of punk stuff, especially lately. That was kind of what I started out with, and I moved through a bunch of phases of, like, post-hardcore and heavy metal and all these different things, and folk and bluegrass, and I eventually moved my way back around to just listening to a lot of punk rock again. It's just kind of in my roots. It's kind of still remains to be my favorite. I always go to the cinema by myself. It sounds nice. You don't have to share popcorn with anyone. This goggle road bullshit is pissing me off, though. And so I'm kind of coming up to a point here where I'm tempted to kind of call the stream. You just missed the Cave? Where? Is it out on the highway? I'm sitting here saying that I want to quit playing because this is frustrating me. Is it down in the old mine road, or do I have to go up into the highway? I can't put the goggles in the highway, so it has to be down in the old mine road. Elbow, a British band like Coldplay but better. A great band for when you're feeling down. Well, that could be worth checking out. Oh, that wasn't the Cave just there, was it? I was told that it was going to tell me Cave. Ah, fuck, I think that was it that I just went past, maybe. I've never really gotten into Coldplay. I have some friends that are super big fans. I've never really given them a chance, I suppose. Well, at least you can enjoy the highway music. When it pops up with the green arrow, it will say exit, but switch to Cave. Oh, I didn't notice that. I've just been, like, glancing, trying to keep track of the full screen and everything, and so I've seen it say exit, and then I've, like, looked away from it, I guess. God damn it. Can't believe I have missed that so many times. I'm so sorry, guys, but at least we got to just chat and hang out in the meantime while I'm cruising around doing lap after lap after lap of all this. That one just stayed as exits, so that's not the one. I'm trying to read conversation stuff on the side here, but I'm also trying to make sure I don't miss the exit for the upteenth time here, which is becoming more and more likely. My god, this section is a pain in the ass, isn't it? Exit, exit, exit. Not Cave. And I think there's three or four of them, so this must be the last one. So this must be the one. Fuck. Nothing. still just regular old exit. I don't know what's going on here. My first concert was 2014, and it was for my favorite band at the time, Hollywood Undead. It was absolutely amazing, even though it was raining and I was freezing my butt off. Man, sometimes you just gotta grit and bear it. Like Alexis on Fire was doing, was it their farewell tour or their reunion tour? It was one of the two. Oh, is the green? There we go. There. Oh God. Okay, I almost missed it again. Jesus. God, that was a pain in the ass. Yeah, I think it was during their reunion tour they put on a show, and it was just freezing rain. It was so fucking cold. But everyone was so high energy. People are just get so into that band. It's incredible. They put on such a good show. The energy spills back in the crowd. The crowd's energy comes back to the band. It's a whole big thing, and I've never had a bad time in an Alexis on Fire concert, even though it was freezing rain. Everyone, like, no one went home. No one was like, oh, I'm too cold. I need to go home. Everyone was super into it. It was fucking great. Okay, let's explore around in this cave now that we finally made it here. Damn, I thought you were going to miss it. I was so close. Was the little green arrow what I was looking for? Eventually the exit thing did change too. I didn't realize that the green arrow might have only been showing up specifically for the cave one. Well, that was close. Yeah, that was down to the absolute last fucking second. And you guys would have been so mad at me. And I would have been so apologetic for wasting your time. Oh, here's the ramp. Finally got the ramp. There's some cool looking shit going on down in these caves though. And probably a couple of these cave fish guys. What is that? There's something going on up here. Some kind of like hologram grid or something. Fortress. Let's investigate that, because that looks interesting as shit. There's like a laser
Everything
light show.
About these guys is creepy. I'm not putting my lips on that.
Are you sure? Sure you don't want to give those big lips a nice smooch? I love Alexis on Fire as well. Every show I've been to of theirs has been excellent. I have seen... Because Dallas Green, the like non-screaming vocalist, he started City in Color afterwards, and then they broke up because it was hard to balance all of that. Him and Wade both had their different shit going on. City in Color was getting very, very successful in the States. It was cool because I got to see City in Color at two different Sasquatch festivals, and the first time he was playing such a small stage, and I had to take the friends that I made in the States and be like, you guys have to go see this. He's like such a good act. He's so fun to see. He's got such a beautiful voice. And then like coming back 2 years later, he was playing again and he was main stage. So he picked up a lot of popularity there, and that was right around when they had to start saying like, all right, I need to focus on City in Color now. I can't do Alexis on Fire and City in Color, unfortunately. But I've seen City in Color 5 or 6 times because they were at Sasquatch at least twice. They played a local festival once. I went and saw them in like the small little venue twice, because I went once with like my brother, I think, and once with my mom. We went to like 2 shows because he played 2 shows in 2 nights. I went to one other one at a much bigger venue around here. And then I've seen Alexis on Fire either 2 or 3 times. So I've seen Dallas Green either 8 or 9 times, him specifically. So City in Color is the band I've seen more live than any other band, and Dallas Green I've seen specifically like so many fucking times. Let's see. The week after I was to leave Adelaide, Ludovico Nuadi was coming to play. I got to go. Wait, you? The week after I had to leave. Wait, so did you miss it? Oh, that sucks. I was so disappointed I didn't get to go. Oh, that sucks, man. I cried after the concert because my favorite member held out his hand towards me and I was so happy. I was alone at one of the sides of the stage. He must have heard me screaming. Oh, that's awesome. That's such a good memory. Such a good moment to have. I feel like I have a couple standout like concert things where you get to have like a really cool moment where you feel like you really get to like have a connection with the band. And that can feel so special and mean so much. And I really appreciate artists who take the time to recognize how important those like minor interactions are and stuff. So that's cool. I'm glad you got to have an experience like that.
Don't think I'm getting in there.
Fuck. I wonder if eventually we're gonna come back. Obviously you can just kick your way in.
Don't think I'm getting in there.
Yeah, at some point I wonder if we're gonna come back and like try and access that in some way. Oh, I was wondering if he was just gonna somehow hook it up magically or like stick in his pocket or something. Nope, he just magically hooked it up to the back of his motorcycle. Doesn't make sense in the slightest, but who cares? I don't actually know Ludovico Inuadi, though. That sounds familiar to me, but I don't think I actually know them. Oh, what? That was my mistake. I was zoning out there for a second. I almost... No!
I better get out of here.
No, you idiot. You didn't take the thing with you.
Go. I don't spelunk.
Go back and get your ramp. Was that supposed to happen? Is that just some kind of like graphical glitch that's going on here? No, it really seems like you just didn't take your ramp, you fool. Oh, what did I do? Oh, whoops. I accidentally closed out of my own stream for a second there. Well, you idiot. Go back and get your ramp. Shit, I keep accidentally clicking off of my windowed screen here. Now I'm back on track. No, get back on your bike. Magically hooked it up. He just pushed it. He just like kicked it and it rolled over and just... Oh yeah, I see what you're saying. Maybe you're making fun of me because I said he magically hooked it up. And realistically, that didn't happen at all. Because the ramp is still here. I guess he just pushed it near. Then why did it look like a hitch came out of nowhere and magically connected them? How do you explain that business? He's a classic rock pianist. Oh god, why was that hard word so hard for me to get out? Have you seen the Intouchables? Another thing heard of, haven't actually seen. That a classic rock pianist. That does sound like a pretty cool combination though. Hook it up. Do your thing this time. Oh, there we go. Are you shitting me? Okay. Are you good now? Are you all set? Can we leave now, ramp? Or do you have some kind of objection to that, perhaps? I think we better roll on out of here then. There we go. I'm thinking I'm gonna go jump that gorge. Well, obviously that's the next part of the plan. But I think that's right around where I'm gonna leave this stream off. And oh no! Am I about to start getting chased here? Oh shit! Dude, best movie ever, anyways, he did the soundtrack. Cool, might have to check that one out then. I should have assumed I was gonna get chased out of here. This seems very easy. Ramp, ramp, ramp! What? Why? What? What did I do wrong?
And who was he? My brothers, we have been visited by a spirit.
It's a weird assumption to make.
The spirit of Ricky Myron, come to reclaim his ramp.
Why did you leave it here?
He can't use it because he is a spirit.
Then why did you take it?
He's only expressing his anger, which we must honor. Oh, angry spirit of Ricky Myron, we honor your rage.
These cave guys are a little fucked in the head, aren't they? Oh. How do I get to successfully make off with the ramp then? Damn it. His music is absolutely gorgeous. You should check out his song Experience. Oh, I appreciate having like a song recommendation to go off of. Thank you for that. I will have to check that out. All right, what can I do here? I do want to try and make off this ramp before I end off the stream. Maybe there's something right around here. There's not really anything I can interact with on this screen, so I wouldn't think there's much I can do there. Ugh, I gotta go through this whole process of picking the ramp back up again, hooking that shit back up. Is there something I can do to mess up their force field? Ugh, painful hiccup. Really struggling to see what I ought to do here. Alright, what kind of weapons do I have? You need to use the ramp to make them crash. That sounds difficult. Like if I...
I'm not taking any strolls in here.
If I unhook the ramp partway through, do I need to drop the ramp while I'm in the middle of driving, maybe? There's nothing I can do in this screen. It automatically just goes past that one. Oh, okay. So maybe I can unhook here then. In the turn right after the ramp screen. Okay. Oh, so that was always going to happen the first time. I couldn't have done it correctly the first time, I suppose, is what you're saying. It was a spirit. Yeah, I really don't know where they got that idea from. Seems peculiar to me. How? Why did that make them? Oh, I see. He used the ramp to scrape off the road markers. There we go. That makes sense. That seems all set to me, bub. I think we're all set,
looks
Ben.
Good where it is.
I agree. So why don't you hightail it on over to your bike? Yeah, so I guess that always would have played that cutscene. That was always going to happen the first time. I couldn't have done it correctly, because he didn't even stop in that screen before. You guys hear that falcon screech? That eagle, the bald eagle? It's actually a red-tailed hawk. They lied to you, because bald eagles sound stupid. And so red-tailed hawks are the ones who actually make that really cool badass-sounding scream. They're very territorial birds. They will scream at you like crazy. Oh, no. Don't leave your bike. Yeah, they will scream at you if you're like a kilometer away from their nest. You took away the nodes. Yeah, I took away the little markers. That was what Father Torque was saying, is that they like need those markers to see and everything. Oh, he's backing up all the way from the ranch. You're gonna have to drive through the fertilizer, past that busted up car. I wonder if they'll have the continuity. Oh, he's got his booster. So I did pick up the booster at some point then. Whoa! Oh shit, it didn't look like he was gonna make it. The little fan on the bottom gave him that little extra boost. If I didn't pick the fan, but did have the booster and everything, because you can totally do those out of order, would he have crashed? God damn. That would have been brutal. Well, not us Americans. Shit, sorry. Because of the delay, I don't remember the exact context of that there. Trying to think back. Well, this has been fun. Looking forward to the next time when you live stream part 2. I'll try to make it, I'll tweet about it well in advance, a couple of hours ahead of time at least. Hopefully sooner. But I think this is where I'm planning on leaving things off. I have no idea if I'm halfway through the game or anything like that, but this is how long I was planning the stream for. Hopefully next time I can get through the entire rest of the game. That'll be the goal, is to knock this guy out in 2 big streams. So let's see, we have birds back in Australia. Oh, I see. That outright swoop you during nesting season. You're talking about the eagle thing. Bald eagles actually sound quite pathetic. Oh yeah, they're embarrassing. They're embarrassingly bad. And my brother did a lot of work on ferruginous hawks. And they're like the biggest hawks, or biggest raptors, he would call them, in this area. They're massive, massive birds. And then they're like so unintimidating. They just do little like meh, meh. They're very not intimidating birds. Red-tailed hawks, though, they sound badass as fuck. Thank you guys, Bane, Barda, Josh A, Max, I have memes, and sorry, there's probably a few others there. Those are just the ones who have been commenting most recently. Thank you guys all so much for stopping by, for hanging out. Good to have you guys as always. It's been fun. I'm sorry that there were so many hang-ups. Part of me thinks maybe I should have recorded this game like in proper episodes, so I could have chopped it up and stuff, where the parts where I got stuck. But I liked it. I liked streaming it with you guys, and then like we can all throw out ideas for how to solve puzzles and stuff. That was what I wanted. That was what I was looking forward to with streaming this one. So thank you all so much for stopping by. Stay tuned for part 2. Possibly tomorrow, possibly the day after. Might have to get pushed back further, depending. I do have a lot to do, but thank you guys so much for stopping by. Good night if you're going to bed. I personally am going to be awake for another like 7 more hours or something. It's just that I got a busy evening. Glad I could help. Yeah, it was very, very helpful having you, your Bane. That was fantastic. Helped us out of a lot of tight jams. Good night, dude. Can't wait for the next one. So long, guys. Thanks again for stopping by. Always fun having you. Always fun hanging out. So hope you guys all have a great day, evening, night, whatever you got left. So, see you again soon.